And we should be live.
All right, legit, we're live. Welcome back to the Wednesday stream at Zephyr Workshop for the game AEGIS Combining Robot Strategy Game. We are all here this week. Sarah, Breeze, Zach, and Jesse.
Hello.
Sup?
Hi.
I am back from the pits
past
of
Samurai
sickness.
Jack.
Gotta get back.
I gotta get back. Back to the past, Samurai Jack.
What's your season about?
The Saturday of PAX.
God. Sorry, Breeze. I can't go to PAX.
Yeah,
year.
Really. We're gonna. It premieres at 11 o'clock on PAX Saturday night. So it's like
that's
gonna be
fine.
We just find a public TV.
Isn't that fine?
Oh, I bet there's a Samurai Jack watch party at PAX.
There probably
yeah,
is.
That sounds like fun.
I would assume that there's at least a side event going on.
Yeah,
well,
right.
11 at night on Saturday is the concert, so.
Yeah, right?
No.
Well, no one cares about that.
Are the pros playing?
Samurai Jack's way more important.
This year, do we know? I haven't looked. I haven't looked at anything that's happening at PAX yet.
Yeah, I haven't really either. We're going to be at PAX, though. We're going to be at PAX East
yeah, we are.
In 2 weeks. We're going to be set up in the tabletop floor.
Yeah, we are. It's going to be great.
Yeah, it's spinning. There's a reason why it's spinning.
It's spinning, but it's also working.
Oh, okay.
So,
legit.
Oh, right.
I think that's just on our side.
Yeah. All right, whatever.
Yeah, knowing PAX, the concert probably has Pollen Storm in it. That's all I can guess.
So, yeah, we're gonna be at PAX. We're going to be... It's going to set up in the tabletop free play area on Saturday at 6 p.m. right as the doors close on the expo hall. We will be doing a panel called Fighting Robots, Attacking a Theme from... Thank you. We'll be doing a panel called Fighting Robots, Attacking a Theme from Different Angles, where we will be up there with other robot tabletop games, Giga Robo, Mech Deck, PBL Robots, Outchasers, and Rise of the Robotariat. Bam, I remember all of them.
Yeah, very nice.
So, six awesome robot games. Hopefully... I'm gonna see if I can get that. I'm gonna see if I can get the panel recorded so we can put it up somewhere later.
Five
we'll
awesome
see.
Robot games, and then there's this one about combining robots.
Yeah,
I'm kind
like,
of iffy on it.
Yeah, five really awesome robot games, and then just some shit called AEGIS. So that's gonna be really cool. I was really surprised when it was actually the last panel I submitted, like right before the deadline closed. Like we're talking like I submitted at like midnight on the night of the deadline. Because I was like, oh, you know, this would be fun to submit. And then it got in. So it looks like we're going to be talking about how to develop different game systems based on similar themes, where all of our games are about fighting robots, but all of our games are very, very different, as it turns out. So if anyone's going to PAX East, please tune into that. And then we have three other panels we're doing. It'll be great. One where our team members talk about quality assurance in the video game world, along with some other really great people from local studios. It's called The Trenches, War Stories of Game Testing. And then we have another one called Game Designing from Life Experiences, where a lot of video game, a lot of board game design veterans are going to show up, and I'm organizing that panel. I'm not really, like, on it, but I'll probably still be there doing moderation. And then... On the last panel we do, what is the last? What is our last panel? Fighting robots.
The battle decks.
Oh, battle decks. Yeah. I think it's on Friday night. I believe it's on Friday or Saturday night. You can look it up. Battle decks.
Battle decks is always Saturday night.
Yeah, probably Saturday night then. So it's game pitch. Battle decks. Game pitch. Karaoke. Not relevant right now. So it's and that's where all the local game developers from. Worcester and Boston will go up and pitch games that they've never seen before, and it's basically an improv comedy panel. We did it last year. It was really fun.
Super fun. Yeah, people love it. It's going to be a good time. Everybody should go.
Yep.
We need the audience participation.
Yeah.
We need your feedback and your awesomeness and your sign holding, so please come to this panel.
Yeah, it was really good last year. We got a lot of people. So that's what we're doing for PAX this year. We also... I'm posting a new blog post tonight or tomorrow, and you can look at it. You can find out more information on all these panels and our yearly PAX AEGIS promo, which you get for coming and hanging out or playing the game.
That blog post is probably going out sometime around 10 o'clock tomorrow.
Yep. So, yeah, we're going to post that blog tomorrow. It's going to be great. But that brings us to tonight's stream. So, tonight, we have a brand new game mode.
What? We're live?
Oh, yeah. We're totally live. And so, we have a brand new game mode. It's called Combine Rondo, and it's a brainchild of me.
It's both the name and the rules.
Name and the
just
rules.
Just for the record.
Brainchild of me. I don't even remember where I came up with it. I think I came up with it at BGG.
For anyone else, you'd say it's while they were drunk, but Breeze doesn't drink, so
well, no,
we don't
I think
know.
So it's really cool. Like, our game, AEGIS, is about starting with teams of little robots, and you use them to combine up to larger robots. But that's pretty limiting, right? So what happens if we had a...
Is that limiting? I feel like the whole point is
I guess it's actually very...
Virtually unlimited.
It's actually virtually unlimited. So, but the thing is, like, what happens if you can use the larger robots from the start? Your level 2, 3, 4, and 5 robots. Because normally...
We've gotten the feedback where people are like, I want to see the big dudes right away. So
yeah.
We're like, how do we do this?
So in a normal game of Aegis, if you want to bring out your big dudes right away, it's usually you just, like, get raffle stomped because you put all your eggs in your basket on turn 1.
It's less that you get raffle stomped and more that you, like, you usually have to take a turn or two off, and most people just aren't willing to do that. like when the option is, okay, I can make my big guy, but that means that my opponent moves twice for free. There's some drawback to doing it too early. And that's intentional. It's designed to make it so that you can't just combine into the big guy and win every game you play. But it also means that if you're playing the game normally, without a focused strategy on making a level 5, you don't do it that often. Or without making a level 3, you won't necessarily do it every single game.
Mm-hmm.
So this is really a game mode to try and show off some of those higher level robots.
Yeah, so it's like, this game mode's a really big, splashy, ridiculous combat. It'll be a lot of fun as Kettle installs the game pieces.
Put the wrong save on.
Oh, that's great. This allows you, in a normally just game, you can only have like one level 3 in play, for instance, because you only have 5 robots on your team, so you'll only ever see one level 3 on your side of the board. In this one, you have 9 points that you can use to build your army, which means if you wanted, theoretically, we haven't nailed this down yet, but I think you can use 9 level 1s.
Yes.
I don't know if that's... I think that might be a little OP.
You'll get past the max energy cap of 25.
I think
the energy design of the game...
I think energy like caps at 25 no matter what. I'm going to call that right now.
That makes
mainly because we're not making markers for...
Because that probably maybe balances
out. But what if I have a 30-sided die?
A 30-sided die?
To track my
energy.
Oh,
of course, yes.
Then shouldn't I be allowed to use all of my energy? What if I want to play a team of 9 S-types?
If you want to play a team of 9 S-types, then congrats. You only have 25 energy to use.
That defeats the purpose of playing a team with 9 S-types. I want 45
it's really
energy.
Stupid. But,
what are you going to spend it on? They can't all move.
Lasers.
So you have 9 S-types.
Just going to dump 45 into Stell?
Fire the lasers!
So there's 9 points that you have, which means you can have 9 level 1s or 3 level 3s, which is very, very powerful, or like a level 5 and a level 4.
Or like a level 5, 2 2s, or a level 5 and 4 1s, or...
Yeah.
There's a whole bunch of different options.
So there's like the team building. The cool part of Aegis is that, yeah, it's team building, but in this game mode you can still do the team building, but obviously this is not meant... to be a competitive format.
So the other thing about this one is that we haven't really gone over yet, is that not only can you start with all of those robots, but you can actually in this game mode start with the combines already made.
Yeah, and that's the main deal.
You are still allowed to combine as well in this mode, though.
Yes.
Yeah, so you could start with 9 level 1s and combine up into bigger things throughout the game if you wanted to play that game. But you can also just start the game with a couple of level 3s in play, saving yourself the energy cost and the time to make them.
And just as a note, when combining, if you combine, say, 2 level 2s, you can sacrifice one of the combined robots on that to make a rank 3 of a certain letter type. I don't know if I'm explaining that correctly.
Wait, what did you just say?
You can combine 2 rank 2s to make a rank 3 still and ditch one of the robots.
Yeah, I believe. Yeah, that's totally a thing in the normal game, too. Like, if you really want to ditch a robot, you can combine into a rank 3 from 2 rank 2s.
As long as it's illegal.
As long as it's, like, legal,
blah, 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 et cetera, et cetera. You have to be able to have made the robot that you're combining into.
Yeah, that's, like, that's, like, that's an edge case rule because, yeah, so it's a way for players so they don't lock themselves out of a level 3 if they make two level 2s because that's just a feel bad. But, yeah, so that rule carries over. I don't – there is no scrap combining in this mode as far as I know.
No, because you have 9 robots. And plus, you shouldn't
and
scrap.
And you can only scrap combine with level 1s anyway.
Yeah, so it would limit team building more than it would empower it. Yeah. So –
In this case, I believe...
And also, in this game mode, there's a lot going on, so we wanted to trim out things like combine.
Like scrap combining.
Although, I guess, I'm pretty sure in both of these teams, you can make an extra rank 3 to the one that's already on there with the subunits.
So I have one question for you.
And what's that?
I have all of these cool combine robots that I'm starting the game with. Do they do things when they come in, like
no.
the combine robots normally do?
So that's something that we're also going to figure out with this game mode, but for now, no.
So I have another question for
yes.
you. The Esperiza
yes.
specifically has a combined commander ability
yes.
to replace her usual commander ability.
Doesn't replace
Does she
it.
Get
ni- she just doubles
she,
down.
She just doubles down. Do I get neither of those if I start the game with an Esperiza?
No, I think Esperiza, she still has basic arrest mandate, so she should use
Does
still...
she have basic arrest mandate?
Yeah.
Okay.
So you, if you start with her Esperiza, you do get to arrest mandate one of my guys.
Okay. So I do get to arrest mandate regardless because yep. the rules of arrest mandate specifically say when you start with the robot or combine. So I don't get to double arrest mandate, but I do get to single arrest mandate.
In this game, yeah, I want to figure out, we can
Because if
can
you
probably...
look at the card, arrest mandate is still down there in orange. The second arrest mandate is actually the green combine ability with stock.
Or you just get to do it again.
Is some background music for the 3-2, by the way. I don't know.
What's up?
The 3-2 puts on Dodon Pachi.
Oh, I know that song. Very good. No, we're just weaving out over here. It's fine. So, all right, let's start the game. But yeah, we're gonna figure out a way to incorporate combine abilities into combine Rondo because I think that's funny. Like I'm thinking, like maybe at some point you'll just maybe you give up a robot's action for a turn and you can just activate their combine ability once per game or something. And it'd be really stupid. It'd be really stupid. But
it makes the
Gon
2000 pretty powerful.
Yeah, you can just
potentially just randomly defense buff your team for free.
Yeah, exactly. And like a really big pinch, you can act. It's like
I'm sorry, I'm under the impression the Gon is already really powerful.
Actually,
that robot destroys my day.
It also makes the Ender 1000 very powerful because you can just randomly move 7 for free.
I think that's really cool because like their one use ult, like their combines become ults and the game becomes League.
The Arc Ninja combine, you get a one use flicker whenever you
want
it.
Yeah, so. But this is obviously an advanced game mode. You don't play. This is not your first game of Aegis.
Yeah, there's too many.
Because the whole thing about the level 1 robots are designed to be simple. The level 2 robots are designed to
either
be.
That,
you're only supposed to look at like one or two of them at a time.
Either that, or it's the game mode of Aegis you use when you're first teaching like your 6-year-old cousin who just wants to play with the giant robots.
Yeah.
Because this lets
you
play with
like,
the biggest robots.
Even then, you probably don't want to put like.
You probably just start with like a level 5 and let them play with that for a while. You
yeah.
probably don't do that. Because
a lot of
too
our.
Much stuff.
Yeah, like a lot of our level 2s, 3s, 4s, and 5s have like 3 attack boxes and like 4 abilities each. And that makes sense in the normal game mode because you only look at one or two of them at a time. In
yeah.
this game, you just start with 4 of them, so you have, like, 15 things to look at.
Yeah, like, just
start.
Looking at the Ion 5000 for a second here, it's one of the, in my opinion, simpler level 3 robots, and it still has a lot going on. So it has, both of its attacks are energy burn, which is already a little different. It has a melee attack that also has force to push people away, in addition to doing a bunch of energy burn damage. Its second ability has piercing, so it goes through things. It also has a radius, which interacts very awkwardly with
We actually,
piercing.
I think we took piercing. We either took piercing or radius off in the final
okay.
version.
So one of those is not on the final
so
version.
So we made the card make sense in the final
set.
Version.
So right now it doesn't make any sense. But let's say that we took one of those off. It still has a mechanic that's kind of complex, either
yeah.
radius or piercing. Then in addition to that, it has energy siphon, so you gain energy based on the energy damage dealt. Then it also has retaliate, so that it can hit things back. So that robot, which I would say is one of our more like top-down designs,
and then when you look,
is very complex.
Yeah, because this guy.
Then when you look at how those two abilities interact, when you retaliate, you Mega Pulse or punch someone, deal damage, gain your 4 energy back, which gives you the energy for another retaliate as long as you keep succeeding.
Which
yeah.
perfectly makes sense because he's about as complex as looking at like 2 or 3 robots at a time in
yeah.
the normal game mode. But in this game mode, you're going to have to look at him and, like, 4 other schmucks.
Yeah, there's
and,
a lot going on.
So you have to be comfortable with Aegis before you start.
I actually rather enjoy the Ion.
Ion's great. All right,
doing pretty
so
good. 3-2, how are you doing?
Let's do the rolls.
Oh, I guess you answered that in the chat already. But...
Oh, no, I need dice.
3-2 asks how everyone's doing.
Dice.
I love you, 3-2. I got an 11.
That's not an answer to the question. The question was, how are you?
We're all doing.
I got a nine.
You feel the love tonight.
All right, yeah. No. Okay, so I'm gonna go
I
first.
I was doing wonderfully.
I'm gonna.
Until I started singing.
Alright, so while I place my guys, Kettle, tell people about what my robots do.
Well,
I'm gonna,
so
I placed my Sal 5000.
Reese's team has one rank 3 and 3 rank 2s. So the rank 3 here is the ever popular Sal 5000. So the Sal 5000 is pretty fun. It has Regeneration Sphere Nimbus and Degradation Sphere Stratos, which
cloud
are both
names.
Which, yes, they are cloud names.
I'm smart. I came up with the attack names. Anyway, yeah. It's an EGS type, so it's like a mobile armored healer, essentially. It moves a lot, it's tough to kill, and it'll buff and heal other guys around him. But it has this cool thing where EGs and Ss, kind of like their unifying thing, is that they're the three most AoE intensive classes. So he has an ability called Empower, which gives his normally just single target attacks, they give him a big splashy explosion. So he has his top attack is a heal that can heal multiple guys. His bottom attack is the same thing, but damages instead.
I was going to say, you say this is like a healer support dude. This thing's the freaking Terminator.
Yeah, it's like, it's crazy. So he can fly and he can move twice. And
slight
he can
double
heal
move
damage.
Is really powerful because that's you juke around walls while attacking
them. He has a potential max movement of 12. In addition to that, he can attack someone as long as you're willing to spend 15 energy on him to do all of that in one turn. He has Empower, so he can either be a good single target damage dealer or use AoE attacks for a little more energy, which is a really powerful option, and it gives you a chance
but
to
anyway,
do a
I'm
lot
done
of damage.
You.
And the rest of that team, it looks like, is just sort of set up to benefit from the salve. It's some pretty aggressive guys, some pretty beefy guys.
It's a pretty standard
and a long-range deep.
So yeah, this
that's a semi-standard Einar team with a bit of range thrown in. So, following that up, his commander is Einar, starting off in his rank 2 form, which is actually one of my favorite robots in the game. It's a lot of fun to play as.
He has a smashy sword and a shooty gun. He's pretty standard
AG
type.
No, it is not a smashy sword, sir. It is a spinny sword.
It is a spinny sword. He's got that.
Einar just extends his arm and spins in a circle, 2 radius. Can do a lot of damage when you factor in crit, because this thing can do up to like 4 damage in one spin to everything around it. And it's a really good attack to use for retaliation.
Mm-hmm. Alright.
The other thing is Twin Buster Shot, which pretty standard sort of gun attack, but it does arc.
Shoots over walls, which is good on this map.
Also good with retaliation.
Yep. And then we got... So yeah, then we got the from our other melee guy, it's the Ender 5000.
Ender
1000.
Ender 1000, pretty close range.
He's more squishy than the Arc, but he's much farther moving, and he's kind of more of a glass cannon. So
it's not that bad. 5 integrity gets you pretty far sometimes.
So
he doesn't really need a lot of integrity because he kills things.
Yeah.
He also goes fast and he can fly.
He goes real fast. And then
he's also very good against opposing flying units because anti.
And then to round out my team is everybody's favorite goat bot, the SSM 3000, who has
I affectionately refer to it as Rocket Dog.
Rocket Dog. He has 10 range of arcing missiles, and so he can just stay way back and just shoot stuff. And if anyone gets close to him, he can push them away with his gravity burst field.
And so, as we discussed before, you can actually combine 2 rank 2s to make rank 3. So if Breeze gets real desperate, he can combine his Ender 1000 with the SSM 3000 to make the Ender 5000.
Which raises a question. I wonder if I can I combine my rank 2 Ender and my rank 3 Sato to make Ender 5000?
I mean, do
if
you
really
want to sacrifice a rank 3 self?
Because that would be probably pretty terrible, but it's something I guess I could
do. That sounds pretty terrible.
It's pretty
the rank...
within the construction. It's in the requirements, I guess.
I guess
you'd
so. I could
ditching,
do it
like...
in an extreme pinch situation.
Well, actually, hold on.
A really weird situation.
But then does that allow you to combine a level 1 with a level 2 to make a different level 2? Because that's something we've never discussed before.
I believe the rule only applies when you're
combining multiple units. Okay. Then maybe it works. Never had to think about what would happen if you combined a level 3 with a level 2 to make a level 3 before.
That's the only one who'd do that is Breeze. This interaction only happens in this game.
The only one who'd do that would be Breeze. It could happen in another game mode.
It shouldn't, but it could. 2v2, I guess.
Well, even in 1v1, I could.
Breeze, do you have anything?
Oh, you know, you're right, yeah.
Do you have anything you want to say about the under 5,000 real quick? Other than the fact that it is our awesome PAX promo this
year? Oh, yeah, that's right. You get a premium under 5,000 art.
We're supposed to announce that tomorrow.
Oh, whatever.
Wow.
But we have a... Spoilers. You get a premium under 5,000 art piece drawn by Steve Gibson, who did Grimslingers.
Real nice looking game.
It's a really sweet piece of art. You'll see a picture of the card tomorrow. So that's our PAX promo this year. Anyway, so let's get the game rolling.
Well, we haven't gone over Jesse's team yet.
Well, yeah.
Yeah.
Jesse's team is a bit more focused on the buffing and the debuffing to survive, because Breeze just has some standard heavy hitters. Start off with, we got the Ion 5000, who we discussed earlier. Pretty good punch bot. If this thing gets up close to you, your team is going to be drained of energy. And possibly shoved off the map or into a wall because of force. And this map's got a lot of walls.
It probably is. Mm.
There are many walls on this map.
Now, following that up, we've got the Snow 6000, which is a big, tanky dinosaur laser. The main thing with this, though, is it has a really, really powerful buffing laser at the top there. EP laser Lambda.
Whoa, God.
That's some...
We actually just 5 seconds ago got the first draft of our new Kickstarter video, so I'm just taking a picture and taking a look at that right now in the background.
So what this laser does is it gives a +2 accuracy and defense buff to everyone who's hit by it.
That's cool.
And then it also has a -2 accuracy debuff that can put on opponents.
That can crit,
which is pretty solid on this team.
I like that.
Because this team's already pretty evasive.
Yeah.
Following that up, we've got Esperiza, who is Jesse's commander. Yeah. So the Esperiza does not have any attacking moves, but has a real strong AoE evasion down, which lets all these other robots hit better.
That's multi-hit.
Yep, so if you put an evasion down on somebody, Ion 5000 can get real easy retaliates on them with that Mega Pulsar
Punch. Particularly if you've already put an accuracy and a defense boost on the Ion 5000, then it always hits. Also, can I have a power cord?
Oh, yeah.
Because my battery power is at 6%.
Oh, boy. Here you go.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Did you bring a charger for the big guy?
Okay. Oh, no.
We can.
I may have powered down.
Oh, no.
Oh, no.
I apologize. This was not my intention.
You are still in the game.
I probably won't be for very long because my screen is currently black.
Anyway.
Well, while Jesse signs back in, the final robot on his... Yes, he just disconnected. Yeah. The final robot on this team is the Goth 100, who is just general G-type. So the Gon has self-defense buffs. The Goth buffs everyone around it rather than itself. So you can slowly advance along with the Goth and just keep the rest of your team relatively healthy. Which, pretty useful.
Yep.
And then, finally, the Esperiza can combine with the Goth to make the Esper 4000.
Also, Jersey is here.
Yep.
Yes.
Okay.
So, anyway, Jesse's computer...
I'm resuming the Windows.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Jesse's computer boots in, like, a half a second.
Yeah,
so.
It does. It's the best. It's
SSDs are a great thing, Breeze.
Anyway, sorry for the technical difficulties.
Yeah, apologies.
So,
do you have anything to say
about the Esper 4000, Breeze?
It's really good, and I think I changed the stats on it for the final print, but I forgot to what.
I think the stats on this card have changed
a lot.
It's power 20 times.
Its power used to be 2, and that was way too good, but now 1's not good enough, so I think I just dropped its accuracy to 4, so now it will do a decent average of damage.
I will reconnect to the server.
Anyway, Esper 4000 is one of my favorite robot designs. I think it looks really cool and spoopy.
And it can actually do a surprising amount of damage.
Oh, yeah, sometimes it can arbitrarily do, like, 8 damage. it's pretty cool.
Yeah, but it was scary when that power used to be 2.
And it could do up to, what was it, up to 12 damage?
Yeah.
With the crits?
Yeah, if you rolled a 4 sixes.
If you rolled mono 5s or mono, oh, yeah, mono 6s.
Yeah. That was pretty great.
Alright, I'm back.
It also, fun fact, used to have a second attack, which was basically a giant pocket sand.
Yep.
Yeah, that was
the one you've got.
But Turns out when you already have evasion 3, you don't need a pocket sand all that much.
It's mostly redundant and no one ever wanted to use it because you'd much rather just shoot with your level
3. The guns are pretty satisfying to use. Yeah.
So, all right, cool.
Let's do it.
I'm ready. Ready to do it. You're up, please.
All right, so let's see. All right, so I'm going to start the game. It's going to be cool. This is Breeze Grigas, brilliant game designer. This game modes will be very balanced, and this game will go exactly as I expect it to.
Exactly as I expect it to.
All
according to your design?
All according to my design. As in, I'm expecting it for everything to blow the hell up in like 3 turns.
Joe and Julie has to request that Jesse talks 12. About Excel stuff.
Oh man, that's a lot of effort.
Joe, that's premium content. You have to pay extra for that one.
You'll have to subscribe to our 17. Channel or donate to our PayPal. In the description.
My team starts with 24 energy, which is cool. So zoom in on my board and you're going to watch this. There you go. So Sal 5000 can move 6, and he can move right over this wall. So I'm just going to go aggro with him. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Oh, wait. Hold on. I had to do a thing before your game start. Before you start your turn.
Oh, okay.
I have a special ability.
Oh, no. Oh, are you going to arrest
mandate? Called arrest mandate. Okay. I'm going to arrest mandate the Sal.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
So that means that whenever I target the Sal with an attack, I can gain reroll 1.
So,
all right, so I move myself forward, and Jesse has pretty much responded by saying if anybody attacks myself, they will get better accuracy.
I wasn't really responding to it. I wanted to at the beginning, but that's fine.
It's the best move anyway. 1, 2, 3.
Yeah.
4. That guy can move 3, right? Yeah.
Yeah. Yep.
2, 3. All
right. It's printed right on your chip.
It is.
So that guy.
In the final version of the game, we think we just... let's see. These are going to be standees, obviously, just to remind everybody who isn't familiar with our stream. This is not what the final game looks like. We're getting new board art.
We're getting new a lot of things.
Yes.
This is just to get it working in Tabletop Sim.
Boom. There you go.
The least painful way possible, yep. Which involved putting not a ton of time into setting up the pieces.
But also
this reads a lot better in T-Sim.
Yeah, we wanted top-down pieces for Tabletop Sim so people could actually see what was happening.
I would like to apologize. My artistic talent is much lower than that of Sarah.
5.
No, you drowned some pretty good arrows there,
so,
let's say.
I moved 7, 6, 13, and then 16, and then 20. So I moved 20, so I'm down to 4, and that will be it for me.
Alright. So you are.
Breeze's team is going fast.
Mandated by the arrest.
I am mandated by Jesse's arrest.
I am going to start my turn. Is this accurate, 21 energy?
Yes, it is.
All right, I'm going to start my turn with 21 energy. I have a much less aggressive team, and my team kind of wants to stick together a little bit more, I think, than Breeze's does. So I'm going to be careful about how I move my guys.
Yeah, that snow is probably just going to dirtle in the back.
So I'm going to move up 1, 2, 3, 4 spaces to start things off, which will put me down to 17. Then I'm going to move the snow 1, 2, 3 to give myself some reasonable lines. Then I'm going to do a little bit of quick line tooling here as I look at approximately how far away I am from this ender, the answer being approximately 15, because I find that this is just about accurate.
About 13 hexes, actually. But, yeah. Going at diagonals.
Yeah, it's close enough.
Yeah.
For my purposes, it gets me what I needed to know, which is that the Ender 1000 is out of range, but that the Salve 5000 is probably in range, because it's always in range. So then I'm going to move the Esper Isa up 1, 2, 3 spaces. Putting me to 11. And then I'm going to move the Goth 1, 2, 3 spaces.
Fancy.
And then I'm going to use the Goth's defense shell, which always works because it has a 100% accuracy rate, but it will cost me 3 energy. So I go down to 5.
And a 2 radius, so that's going to...
And a 2 radius, so my entire team, except for the Goth, now has +1 defense until the start of my next turn. So... hopefully, if Breeze tries a frontal assault, I will be ready to defend myself.
Mm-hmm.
And that's going to do it for me. Your move.
All right.
It is now the turn of Mr. Brazier.
I'm going to... Let's see. As I said, this is very exciting. We got a nice little demo of our new Kickstarter video. So I'm responding to that guy while I make my move. But yeah, okay, so yeah, what is Jesse doing over here? He's moving all of his people to the right. So you know what? I'm going to move all my people to the right too. And that way we're going to circle. One, two, or wait.
So you just want to make the game about positioning and not about combat?
Oops.
Is that your plan now?
I have a sensitive mouse, apparently.
Evidently so.
All right, so let's see. That's where they were. Maybe I don't. Maybe I want to just move 12 spaces and try to nuke you.
Just so you're aware, all of my robots except for the goth have plus one defense.
Fuck. One,
language two, three, breeze. This four, is a family five, stream.
Six, is it? Because we're on after nine, prime 10, time.
12.
Look, you need to subscribe for our subscription service, Zephyr After Dark.
Zephyr After Dark, yeah.
It's after dark right now. Aren't we just showing them the premium content?
All right.
Yeah, you say a lot of swears, and that's the only thing that changes?
One, two.
No, no, the real premium content is you talking about Excel spreadsheets.
Oh, okay. So I can just show off two-page long formulas again?
All right. So I'm going to go one, two, three,
hey, I had to math
four,
check that formula.
Five, six, seven, eight, nine, and that's two move actions, so I can't wall jump afterwards. But...
Wait. So, that guy doesn't have double move.
The Ender 1000 does not have double move.
Oh, I moved the wrong guy. Whoops.
Nice.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. There you go.
Yay.
All right, so...
I figured it out.
That put me down from 24 down to 15, and now I'm going to pay 2 to empower, and I'm just going to try to nuke Jesse's face.
So you're targeting the ion?
I'm going to target the ion, which okay. I know very much has retaliate.
Okay.
But YOLO!
You're using the degradation sphere Stratos.
I'm going to use the degradation sphere.
Are you sure
sphere.
You don't want to use regeneration sphere Nimbus?
Oh, yeah, we totally fixed that typo.
No, are you sure you don't want to use regeneration sphere Nimbus on my robot?
Regeneration sphere. All right, I'm going to go rolls. I need all these to be 2 or above, because if you don't know how to play our game...
That's how that accuracy number works.
Yeah, big green 3. All of them need to be 2 or above. I get it. So I'm going to try to take like 2.
Take
I 2 guess.
And the goth takes... Hold on. So it has a radius of 2.
Yes.
So it hits everybody but the Esperiza.
Yes.
So the goth goes down to 4 because he takes 2 because he doesn't boost himself.
Yep.
And then everybody else takes 1 damage. Or
Wait,
no.
He takes 3 and everybody else takes 2.
Sorry, he goes to 3. Everybody else takes 2.
Okay.
Apologies. And it's been a while since I have been hit by an AoE salve while having defense buffs.
Let's see here.
And so I'm going to use my retaliate ability on that as well, because I can.
I wonder if Goff should probably boost himself for the sake of intuitiveness.
But then what would make him different from the Gon?
Be better. He'll have less
HP. He won't have Beacon.
Yes.
You lose the duel, you lose your soul.
That's okay. True, I get sent to the robot realm if I lose this duel.
If you lose!
I don't know.
Dude, anybody ever see Get a Robo Armageddon?
Alright, so I'm gonna retaliate.
At the end, if you're badass enough, you just get to go to the robot realm to fight with robots for all eternity.
I'm gonna retaliate with Mega Pulsar Blast. And I also need all 2s or better, which I got. So I will drain your energy for 1.
Oh, yes, I'm getting owned. Okay.
And I will gain back 1 energy for the turn.
Sweet.
With that sick energy siphon ability.
Alright, so you burned me for 1.
So I burned you for 1.
6.
And everyone in a radius of 2, which is no one.
Alright, legit.
If you moved over a hex, you can then pierce through and hit the wall.
So I only have 10 energy left, so I guess that means I will just move this guy 1, 2. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and, no. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, so I'm not in the range of his gigantic laser. Then
dude, you know there's a wall there.
2, 3.
And then I
well, if I were to put him exactly where I wanted to, I would have been right on axis for your laser. I was just like, I'm gonna fly.
Gotcha. Right
the
away.
Only space where you can hit me. This is my strategy. I'm down to 0. Okay.
All right. Is it my turn?
Absolutely.
I go back up to 21 energy. Because that's how that works.
All right, so Jesse is all bundled together. He He's probably going to own my face. Because I also parked right next to a wall, so Mr. McSmash is probably just going to punch me into it.
I'm going to start things off with an EP laser lambda.
Oh my god, what
actually,
does that do?
Wait, hold on. Let me understand my robots for a moment. Because I think I can make this a really awkward, very convoluted turn.
Oh, I'm sure you can.
Hold on.
Those are the best turns to use against Breeze.
If I spend three on that.
Yep.
And then I spend...
Well, you spend five on the laser.
Five on the laser. That puts me up to 8. 9, 10, 11, 15, plus 3 is 18.
So, like, the Snow 6000...
Okay, I can do it. Oh, all right, God. We're going for it. So are you ready?
The Snow 6000 is, like, the ultimate support unit. His EP Laser Lambda will just buff the hell out of somebody.
Are you ready to get hype?
Okay, so we're going to see Jesse right. Wombo combo right now.
I am using the Esperiza's ability.
All right, hover the Esperiza. All right.
Jamming Spore Cloud.
So it's going
to target. Done, done.
What are you doing?
Ion 5000.
What are you doing?
I'm going to roll these three dice.
Why are you targeting the Ion 5000 with an evasion deck?
Jesse, you're good.
I'm going to roll these three dice.
All right.
The only downside to this strategy is that I'm potentially offering up my Goth to be destroyed, but I think it's worth it.
All right, let's go.
So for each one of these, my evasion is decreased by one as long as their twos are better. So the evasion of my Ion 5000, my Snow 6000, and my Goth 100 are all reduced.
So you just dropped the evasion of your own guys.
Correct.
Okay.
I want to see where this is going now.
For three energy.
Okay.
I don't know if this is worth it because it's impacting a lot of robots, but I think it's pretty useful.
But this is...
Now I'm going to use the EP Laser Lambda to target the Ion 5000.
Which does not have aim, so it just
Which does
hits.
Not have aim, so it always hits, yep. So I don't have to reroll.
Yep.
Which okay. is really helpful because I just rolled two ones.
Okay.
So now the Ion 5000 has plus two defense and plus two accuracy, so it always hits.
Okay.
Then I'm going to use the Goth, and I'm going to Defense Shell, which also always hits. So that puts a plus one defense boost on all of my robots except for the Goth itself. So now my Ion 5000 has plus three defense.
Okay.
And plus two accuracy, so it always hits.
So I'm not damaging him next turn.
So you cannot hurt the Ion 5000.
You can try his lowered evasion.
Who is now going to move up. You could potentially double attack it if you were out of range. So I'm going to move up four spaces. Actually, wait, hold on. Not those four spaces. I'm going to move one, two, three, because I was here. I'm going to move three spaces.
Okay.
And then I am going to use the Mega Pulsar Punch,
all right.
which is a melee attack that now always hits that has force and energy burn. And I'm going to burn your robot for four energy.
All right. So you punched me in the face.
I punched you in the face.
I can do nothing about it.
You can do nothing about it. Okay. You get burned for four energy.
Okay.
Which puts you down to two energy production on that robot.
And I
you also get pushed into the wall for four, so you take two damage.
All right, so my guy has four HP, and he generates two energy.
Correct.
Okay.
And I buy back. So I moved one, two, three. I spent my last four energy, and I gained back four energy because I hit you for four energy.
Because, yeah, I have 5,000 as energy siphon.
So I still have energy left for retaliates.
Are you yeah, I guess so.
And that's what I got.
All right, so that was pretty cool. This is the sort of thing that you can only find in Combined Rondo.
yeah, it's also a lot of
effort. Or four player.
And I don't know if it would...
Or four player.
I don't know if it actually worked out for anything meaningful. Well, I might have destroyed my own team doing it, but it looked cool.
You did effectively reduce my my guys pretty nicely.
I think I made it so that you can only really fight me with one guy.
So I start with five less energy now, total.
Yeah.
So I'm at 19. And that means, so what are your defense buffs?
So my Ion 5000 has plus...
Yeah, he's like impervious. I'm not going to try to attack him.
My Snow and my Esper have plus one, and my Goth has nothing. My Goth is essentially
okay.
a sitting duck here.
Let me see if I can get in one good pot shot.
I mean, you can potentially just destroy my Goth and do massive damage to my other two guys here, but I still think it was worth it.
I think that was a pretty cool wombo combo.
It might have been better to just push you away from me to make you expend more energy to get back in.
I think you might have... I think you probably could have just hit me with the jamming spore cloud and gotten off But it would have been less cool.
Well, but then I wouldn't have gotten the defense buff on the ion.
Oh, that's true.
The defense buff on the ion was the goal.
Oh, yep, yep, yep.
It's also going to be more effective this turn. Because I can do the same thing, but also to accuracy debuff your, or evade debuff your guy first.
Technically, you could accuracy debuff his guy too.
I'm not going
So I moved I moved four spaces, and I'm going to pay five energy. So that's three plus a two tax.
And it's guaranteed to hit.
Yeah, it is. So, I'm going to deal three damage to Goff.
Yeah, so Goff is dead.
And then two damage to the other two guys.
And so my other two guys go down to three and two, respectively.
Okay.
I'm assuming you're targeting something relevant, and you have not a laser, so that's how that works.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. And I can zoom my guy.
That's unfortunate.
I can zoom my guy over.
Out of range of that. So that's probably where it becomes real bad.
Oh, actually, I can't even do crap there. I just I only have 10 energy left.
Yay!
So actually, the energy burn kind of screwed me here, because if you didn't energy burn me, I would be able to unload, zoom in with the thing I just did. Zoom in on Ender. So I just flew my Ender over here, and I would normally be able to just unload my machine guns.
And
on,
destroy the snow?
Yeah.
But in this case, you cannot
On Gangrenosaurus,
so.
As I call him. Or as Ryan calls him. So, but now I don't have any energy. But I'm pretty sure he's not going to die next turn. So, actually, he might, because you're going to try to push me off the board. Let me rethink that. One, two, three, four.
It's like chess.
Five,
once you put
six,
the piece
seven.
Down, you.
Because, like, I can't. If I go anywhere near your guy, if I go anywhere near your ion,
your robot
I guess.
Dies.
Yeah, I don't want to put my guys next to each other, because you're going to push them into each other.
I'm also going to debuff both of them at the same time.
Okay.
There's a lot of things that
so happen. So it turns out I actually just made the worst move I could have possibly made, because I thought I had enough energy to attack you.
No, the worst move you could have possibly made would be just, like...
running your guys away and sacrificing
one,
your robot.
Two, yeah. Three, four, five, six, seven. So I'm going to flank you. I'm going to push him over there.
Okay,
now I have three
fine.
Energy, and I got. I'll move this guy up. One, two... three. All right, I'm dead.
You're done?
I'm dead. Right. I'm dead.
So now, what I have to do is I have to use the Esperiza. So I start at 19 energy because I'm down a robot. I'm going to use the Esperiza. I'm going to again target my Ion 5000 with it.
Okay.
So I'm going to spend 3 energy. I'm going to roll 3 dice for each die that's a 2 or better. The evasion of both my ion and your salve is reduced. And that is 2 successes, so we both have evade minus 2.
Which is all you need.
Which is all I need. So then the ion is going to move over 1 space. The ion is going to use its punch, which puts me to 11 energy, and then will put me back up to 15 because energy siphon. I can roll these dice, but they're going to 16.
He does only have 2 energy left.
Yeah, but he's also going to get pushed off the board.
So you don't go back up to 15, though?
Oh, that's a good point. I only go back up to 13. Fair. So I go up to 13 energy. The salve gets pushed off the board. So the salve is dead.
Okay.
Pining for the
He also fjords. Goes to 0 energy, because that mattered.
Okay.
Then I will use the... Snow 6000 to... accuracy boost, defense boost? Yeah, I'm going to accuracy boost and defense boost, but not before I move. Hold on.
But not before you move, but only after you move.
I'm going to move to...
So, Jesse's still wombo comboing.
Here, and then I'm going to spend...
The Snow 6000 is pretty good at wombo comboing.
Wait a second, I just looked away for like a second, and... Oh, did you kill myself?
Yes, launched it off the board.
Oh, absolutely, okay, cool.
And also reduced its energy to 0 simultaneously. Gaining plus 2 off of my energy siphon ability.
So yeah, I love the Ion 5000 is probably my favorite level 3 because it's like based on Big O.
So the Ion 5000 is again defense boosted.
Big stupid fist.
That's gonna do it for my turn.
See, I've always thought it looked like one of the Jaegers from Pacific Rim.
Yeah, he's also he's the most similar to a Jaeger probably.
You are up. I have 5 energy in my pool.
So like I referred
to Ion has plus 2 accuracy, plus 2 defense, and minus 2 evasion.
Okay, and minus 2 evasion. This is actually a really cool combo.
I really like Ion 5000 plus Esperiza. It's pretty cool.
Alright, so let's do...
Hey, that's valid in a regular gameplay.
Yeah.
6, 8...
You're potentially destroying your own robot for it, but it's valid.
So I am now at 17 because that was most of my energy was coming from big men. All right, so now this is actually...
This is not probably... over for Breeze yet. He still has two really strong
robots. I think it's still... I'm pretty sure it's still in my advantage.
I definitely suicided a lot of free damage that I didn't necessarily have to.
Now, question for this game mode. Is scrap combining a thing?
Two,
no. You have nine robots.
Four?
Also, he doesn't have any level ones.
Jesse, I'm trying to get you an Esper 4000 here.
Listen, I don't need it.
All right, so I'm going to move four there. All right. You have a two defense buff?
I have a plus two defense buff, but you hit me all the time.
So oh,
you can do
shit.
Two damage.
So I guess I'm dealing two damage. I'm just gonna pay four and deal two damage to you then. I'll roll the dice for show and glitz.
Alright.
Are you going to retaliate?
I am going to retaliate.
With your perfect accuracy mega pulsar
blast. Oh yeah, that's right, I didn't.
Accuracy mega pulsar blast.
There's my roll. Spoilers, I hit.
And then I'm going to hit.
Oh,
with
no.
My roll, because that's how these games work, is that you pretty much
zoom
have
in on the two robots fighting dynamically. Alright,
so then I do an energy burn of damage to your Ender 1000.
Okay. So my dude now makes four instead.
Why is that text centered? It has ruined the aesthetic.
I don't know.
So that was silly.
That was something.
Alright, so did I already minus my 4 energy to use that attack? I moved
over
like 6 spaces.
So I spent 3 and I gained back 1, so I still have 3 energy, just in case.
Looks like you spent your energy, I think.
Did I?
You spent...
I started
7,
at 15.
You spent a total of 7 to do that.
Yeah.
Oh, okay, so yeah, I only moved over
4
like 3
spent, spaces. Or move 4, spent 4. You spent a total of 8. You have 7 energy left.
Okay, yeah, that makes sense.
Yeah, you're good.
Alright, alright, what else? 1, 2, 3, 4. Bonk.
Feel like that wasn't planned through.
And then let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, I can shoot you.
Oh, that's bad for me.
1, 2, 3.
That's four. Very bad for me.
However, I don't think you do any damage to you.
You
oh wait,
could
no, I do.
Potentially, if you roll 2 threes or better,
oh,
you'll
true.
Actually win the game probably.
Oh no.
Because that's the downside of my accuracy debuffing strategy.
Increase armor forever, but decrease evasion forever.
Yeah. I get some pretty powerful buffs that always hit, but the downside is that...
Gonna do dumb stuff. I hit with 1, so I actually just plink off of you.
All right, plinked. We got there.
I got nothing.
Still at 2 integrity. Retaliate.
Oh, my God. So, Jesse can't hit my guy back because I'm hitting him from behind a wall.
But what I can do is hit the Ender.
And then...
Again.
So he's just shooting my Ender again like a jerk.
So the Ender is going to lose another energy production, going down to 3.
All right.
Which won't really matter because
I'm
probably just going to eliminate all of its energy production next turn.
So yeah, I'm slowly just getting burned out. So yeah, go.
You have 1 energy left?
Yep.
Mm.
Yeah, which I really can't do anything with.
It is now Jesse's turn.
So I'm back up to 19 energy. I am going to... You have how much energy production next turn? 3 plus 6 plus 6, you have 15.
Currently has 15.
I'm going to flip this guy over so I stop looking at its stats. Let's see, what do I want to do? I want... to... accuracy and defense boost my ion.
That's fair.
So I'm going to go down to 14 energy.
So yeah, Jesse's got like...
I'm going to roll 5 dice.
Uh-oh.
I need to get no ones, but I do have a reroll.
Look at your guy.
You are
and
good.
And that succeeds. So the ion gets plus 2 accuracy, plus 2 defense. So then I am going to try and get your...
I was going to say, you should...
Just remember, Jesse, you can technically use the Esper Isa combined with either of your other guys and make the Esper rank 3.
That is an
in
option.
A pinch.
You could also just shoot me with the snow as other things, and you could drop my accuracy so I just don't do anything to you.
But I think I'm better off...
Probably just getting the hard buff on defense.
Getting the hard buff on my ion. And then spending 3 plus 4. So I go from 14 to 11. And then I go from 11 down to 7.
Yep.
And then I will hit with this attack. So I'm going to push you back 4 spaces.
Punch!
And I'm also going to drain you for the rest of your energy, buying back 3 of my own energy.
So I knock my... Yeah, I'm knocked back 4 spaces. 1.
That guy produces 0 energy.
Yeah, my guy produces nothing. So now I'm like, lol. I get 12 energy at the start, which is still probably okay. But I'm definitely not double attacking you next turn, because you just knocked me like back to like 10 bucks.
Yeah, out of range.
Yeah.
Push 4, pretty strong.
And I think...
I got my missile guy back here, but let me think. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
I need to do some planning.
You're nowhere near close enough for me to actually shoot you.
And so then I'm going to move...
I lure you in.
So, Jesse's currently going for the energy drain victory, but might be slightly difficult because there's that SSM in the back.
Oh, yeah.
I'm going to move my Esperiza here for 4.
And although, that's... he can always combine the Esper rank 3, which is pretty good at taking out SSMs.
My SSM does an average of like 1.5 damage per roll, so if he keeps defense buffing by 2, he'll probably get to me before I kill him.
Huh.
It's so, only like a 2, that's only
so
like 2
I'm
turns where I have to kill him
turn.
Too. He can move decently.
Depends on what Einar can do.
I have positioned my Esperiza strategically.
And Jesse has 6 energy left,
and
so
I have
6 for
energy for
punching.
Alright. Well, let's see if how much energy is... How much health does Big Man have?
Big Man has 2 integrity and 2 defense buff.
Oh, I'm going to kill you.
No evade debuff. Oh, no. Are you going to spin?
I'm going to spin.
Spin isn't going to kill me.
Spin might kill you.
Spin probably doesn't do anything unless you roll double crits.
I'm going to roll 2 sixes right now.
Okay. That's a called shot.
So Breeze is using the Whirling Bayonet.
So I moved over 2 spaces.
He's looking for 2, 3 up. And if he gets 6s, they deal extra damage.
I can't retaliate. That's fair.
All right, here comes. 1, 2, 3. Double sixes.
No,
oh, I
no.
saw them. I saw
I
them.
I saw though. Them too, and I heart skipped it, but it didn't happen. Still alive.
Game was trolling Jesse a tiny bit there, but it's trolling Breeze a bit
I
more.
I was teased. So I go. I guess I move over 2 spaces. I'm just gonna try to converge on you.
Yeah.
So how does it feel to be crit blocked? I have red. I have red blue guy and red green guy converging on big purple here. So,
yeah.
It's your boy Ender.
He's rolling
shoot.
4 dice.
He's rolling some 4 dice.
And if. So you need at least 3 of them to succeed, and if you get 4, you kill my guy?
Yes.
Which is not impossible. But did not happen.
Oh, that didn't happen at all.
Alright, I've got to retaliate.
Oh my
and
god.
And so I'm going to retaliate.
Shoot my arc.
By shooting your arc, which is actually also going to hit my own robot, but I think that that's fine. Because my goal here is to tax your energy.
Oh, I have 2 energy left, so I can retaliate your retaliate.
He's not wrong.
There it is. You're going to risk double box cars, Jesse. You're going to get those 2 sixes on retaliate, and you're going to lose. There's the psych out.
Well, you could also retaliate with Twin Buster Shot.
Why would I want to do that, though?
I think it's more likely to do the same thing.
Oh, yes, I do.
Isn't it
2 sixes
same exact
is 2
ability,
sixes,
but,
pretty much.
But, well, 2 fives would do it on that. But
if he uses the Buster Shot and doesn't kill you, you can retaliate. You can't retaliate again against his spin.
That's true.
All right, what you got?
I'm gonna...
What you got, fam?
I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna shoot you. So I have an accuracy boost, so this hits. Both of us are drained by 1 energy, and I buy back 2 energy.
You guys want to
wait,
explain...
what just happened?
Combine Rondo again. We have someone who just entered the stream, and it's probably easier if we talk about what it is.
Oh yeah, that's right. We'll give like
the whole thing out.
We'll periodically.
Yeah, we'll do a quick explanation in just a second after we work
figure out
this
how is Jesse
combat.
How is Jesse kicking my ass right now?
So I'm shooting you with my piercing or with my AoE attack.
Okay.
Yep.
It has a radius of 2, so it hits both of us.
Okay.
Yep.
But I have energy siphon, so I buy back an extra energy off of it. Because I'm hitting both of us. So I'm down 1 energy production overall, but
my
for
brain
this
just broke.
Turn...
Can you energy siphon yourself?
Yes.
I guess
rules is written.
You can 100% do that,
there's
but
no
I guess it's just
down,
never come up
there's
before.
No real like benefit to it. It provides very short-term benefit at long-term cost.
That's
so it's
funny. Okay, sure, whatever.
It's fine.
So you paid energy, you got 2 back, I think.
Yeah, I got 2 back, and I drained you for 1, and I drained me for 1.
Okay, legit.
You have 2 energy left. Are you going to retaliate?
Let's see. So my guy is now generating 5. I have 2. Yes, I'm going to retaliate. I'm going to do Twin Buster Shot. I'm gonna hope for at least two five. I'm gonna hope for two fives. So red green guy is shooting back at him because you can retaliate off of retaliates, and it's really funny. I think it's probably one of the neatest parts of the game. Ah!
Only Blinks. One.
Doesn't okay. do any
again,
damage.
Which right. allows me to retaliate again.
Are you kidding me?
Oh, because yeah. retaliate chains.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
So I'm going to do the same thing I just did.
So this is an interesting thing we found
and
out.
And drain you another energy.
Drain you another energy, too.
And drain me another energy.
So we found out about this thing in our game where you can retaliate retaliation. And we're totally keeping it in. I think it's great. I think it's actually
See,
really
you
awesome.
You could have avoided this if you could try using your spin instead of the buster shot.
That's true.
You would have had less chance of doing any damage, though.
All so... Right. So anyway, let's talk about Combined Rondo. So Combined Rondo, just to go over it again, normally just you get five little robots and you can combine them into big robots. And that's how the game works. You always start with five single letter robots. This game mode, you can start with combined robots on the board, and if you, to tell which ones that you can start with, you have 9 points. And every letter counts as a point.
So,
so
level
you can
five
have,
count, costs five, a four costs four, so on and
three
so forth.
Three costs three. So we're playing this game where you literally, the whole point of this game mode is you can start with the big, splashy, super powerful robots right at the start of the game.
And have multiple of them.
And have multiple of them, and it's really silly.
Which gets you some silly combos, like the Snow Rank 3 with the Ion Rank 3, which doesn't really happen normally.
And yeah, like, so the interactions and the balance is very hard to track, since a lot of these guys are balanced around having, like, one or two of them on the board and not four or five of them. So, you do get some really cool interactions, because the game becomes a bit more complex. Still not as complex as, like, a Battletech, but it's like...
But there is definitely more to keep track
it's
of.
It's more to keep track of and more complex abilities that are flying around. So right now, I have a team... I started with a team of a level 3, a level 2, a level 2, and a level 2. So I had, like, one really strong guy and three, like, demigods. And then Jesse started with two level 3s, so he had two really strong guys. And then one level 2, and then he actually was also using a level 1. Because level 1s can still be used in this. If you want, you can actually use 9 level 1s in this game, and it becomes much more like a Warhammer war game.
Yeah.
But that's also a thing. I think that's... And this is... we have not played this game mode a lot.
This is the... We barely playtested this. It just sounds kind of cool game mode.
Yeah, so, it's awesome.
So, yeah,
I like it a lot.
It's pretty absurd. It's definitely not balanced.
It's not the tournament game mode.
It's not
but it's
fair,
also,
it's
really
fun.
It's balanced by the fact that everything can pretty much be broken.
Everyone is broken.
Everyone
so
is
also
broken.
I'm starting my turn. I have 17 energy.
Okay, so that was my turn. I tried to kill Jesse's big man. I failed.
I'm gonna attempt.
Also, Mechdex says yo.
Those are the best.
Those are the best. So I'm going to try to boost using my laser. I'm going to do the old laser targeting my ion with all the goodness of my crappy drawing right there. And I'm going to spend 5 energy, going to 11. I'm going to roll 5 dice. I need to get no ones. And we got no ones. So my ion is again boosted by +2 defense and +2 accuracy, which means that he always hits.
This ion is currently living on 2 HP. And it is saved by the glory of the Snow's defense buff, which, because Breeze's rank 3 did a lot of damage before it went down.
My entire team is hovering at, like, 2 or 3 integrity and is living based off of, like, exclusively Moxie.
Yeah, really. My big guy was, like, my big damage dealer.
I'm going to succeed on this push from my Ion, which is really good that I got the accuracy boost because I just rolled 2 ones.
Yeah.
And I'm going to push your arc back 4 spaces.
Okay.
He's also going to produce 0 energy.
Oh my god.
So you're down to 6 energy production per turn.
Oh.
And I buy back all of the energy that I just spent to use that ability. So I go back up to 10. And I have the Esperiza who can still move around and do stuff.
Now, you can technically combine your Esperiza with your Snow to make the Esper.
I could technically do that.
That's actually not
wrong.
The worst idea.
But what I need to do right now...
I mean, you could just start shooting me with your lasers, and that would probably do a good job.
Well, what I need to do right now is make sure that no matter what you do, you can't destroy my Snow. So I'm going to move the Iza over a space, just in case.
I don't think I can... With 6 energy, I cannot do anything to that Snow.
You're, like, just out of range, but I'm still moving the Iza in case I'm bad at math.
Okay.
So that's gonna do it for me.
Okay. The risk he took was calculated, so but boy, was he bad at math.
So you're how much energy you got on your side?
I have 9 energy remaining.
Whatever. I'm gonna shoot you with my red blue guy.
Oh no.
So give it the zoom in. Alright, here's the showdown. Gonna shoot with the red blue guy. If you look his card, blah blah blah. I need paying at 4 energy to roll 4 dice. Each one that's 3 above will deal 1 damage, except not, because you have 2 defense buffs.
So you actually have to succeed on a minimum of 2 dice plus another one to do a damage.
So yeah, I have to, yeah, exactly. So each dice will deal a damage. That means all of them have to be successful, and I'll deal 4 damage, except it'll be
minus 2. Minus 2, which will still be enough to destroy my
So he has, he has a 2 damage soak. Everybody gets it. Alright, rolling.
Oh,
one failure.
1 damage.
So that does 1. That puts me down to 1.
I got that 1 damage.
I don't have anything that's worth retaliating on.
Just imagine if you put a healer on this team.
Yeah, it's that'd be like, pretty nice.
It'd be pretty solid.
Bring yourself back just to throw a regeneration sphere in there.
Yeah, right.
Play a snow instead of the goth.
I always forget that the level 3 snow doesn't have a heal.
Yeah, the level 3 snow has a buff, a debuff, and a damaging ability, but it doesn't.
To be fair, level 3 snow, pretty fun.
Wonder if level 3 snow, I wonder if we should just change out the damage for a heal and make it.
No one ever really uses the damage laser, so.
I know, right?
It's hard to use.
Damage laser is strong.
The damage laser is strong, but when I'm buffing a level 3, it gets a lot less strong.
So I have 2 energy left, which means I actually can't do Bubkiss. So I think I'm just gonna. Oh, actually, maybe you're in missile range now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. No.
No.
Absolutely not.
So, one thing Breeze could have been doing all game is slowly advancing that SSM with his remaining energy.
I'm going to try to lure Jesse towards it. So, I'm done.
You're going to try to lure me towards the thing that I have to destroy in order to win the game?
Yeah, I guess so. So, solid. I have 2 energy left, and my guy has retaliate, so let's see what you do.
So, Jesse... What do you think the Ion's going to be doing now? Because you fully drained both his guys.
Maybe you know, that's a good question.
Maybe you should move in with the
And part of the question like, that I want answered is, are there any other level 3s that this team could have made?
You can technically combine your Esper with your Ion and get Esper 3.
To get the Esper 4000. Is there anything else that we've missed?
No.
The other level 3s does not look like it.
I just wanted to confirm that that was the case. Okay, we're good. So I'm going to...
Esper 4000 is kind of the iconic Ixa rank 3, so I want to put that on there.
Huh?
I'm going to move the Ion back.
Oh, ask him who he is. Is that Dan? Anyway, so let's go.
I'm going to move the Ion 5 spaces.
You're going to move the Ion 5 spaces?
Down to 12.
What are you doing? Why is he over there? I looked away for a second. Why is he like on the other side of the board?
I'm gonna move the Esper over.
Just because I have 6 energy doesn't mean I won't kill you. I swear I will dirtle. And I will kill you.
4 spaces.
I have a very unique set of skills.
Because I have flight. I'm gonna move it 1, 2, 3, down to 10.
One of those unique skills is rolling dice.
I'm gonna move the snow a space.
My god.
I'm going to spend
5 energy.
5 energy.
And to shoot me?
For the damaging laser.
Oh boy.
Because now I've crippled your energy production, but I still really don't like that you have these turrets that are sitting around doing damage to me. So I'm just going to try and blow them.
Oh.
So I'm going to shoot the Ender 1000.
I know that name.
I rolled 1-1.
Reroll 1.
I have 4 remaining, so
re-roll.
I am going to use that reroll. Whoops, sorry, there's the actual reroll.
Yep.
Which succeeds.
So I guess
Freeze, don't you wish you were getting rolls like that this game?
That's really funny.
3 sixes, a 5, and a 4.
So I got nothing. So alright.
So it's your turn.
Alright, come at me.
So the damaging laser has been used.
So to clarify, I have 2 guys in the center of the board. I can't really do anything with them because I have no energy. I have 6 energy production per turn. And anyone who, you know, knows how to play Aegis means knows that means I can...
Which is almost all of the energy you need to launch your rockets if you were in range. So
yeah.
It's a pretty precarious...
And I have to get in range of your robot in order for me to actually be able to end the game.
The other thing is, Jesse does not have to fully drain the SSM. He just has to take 2 energy off it.
I can do anything. Because you need 5 energy to continue when you're playing. But yeah, so I have 6 energy. And I moved my guy 3 spaces, and I have 3 energy, because every energy is a space in Aegis. And so...
Every energy and every dice.
Every energy and every dice. So now that means I also don't have enough energy to really do anything, so I'm just going to move this guy up. And he's going to go over here and be a turret. So here's so now we've officially stopped playing Aegis, and now we are playing Field Runners. So Jesse's going to attempt to move his guys down that lane, while my guy behind the wall shoots at him, and my guy he's trying to run to also shoots at him. It's going to be like that scene in the Transformers movie where they're all like running down.
We are working on a StarCraft II mod, Aegis Tower Defense.
Absolutely. All right, go, all Jesse.
I'm going to go. I'm going...
Oh, no, you're going to Ion.
It should be noted, though, while he's running down that corridor, I don't have enough energy to actually shoot him with both of my weapons. So,
that's true.
So I can shoot you with my red-green guy.
But he only has one life. All
right, guy. I have 17 energy. We're going to do this in a different way from the way that everybody was talking about doing this. Are you hype?
Okay.
I'm pretty hype.
By firing a damage-dealing laser.
So Jesse needs to get from here to here.
I'm going
to
do a damage to your ender.
Remember, sixes are for closers, Jesse.
I'm going to spend one energy to reroll.
Successes are for closers.
Ooh. I failed it.
You don't got those brass balls.
So, I have 11 energy left. That's fine. So with 11 energy, I'm going to move this robot up two spaces.
Always be closing.
And I'm going to move this robot up two spaces. And I'm going to spend six energy to combine them.
Okay, so now you're just going to hope that I don't deal free damage to you.
Breeze, but I have vanish when I
combine. Oh my god.
Breeze, so your rule of can you combine a rank 2 and a rank 3 to make a rank 3 is coming to fruition.
It did come up. I give it that. So that's the thing. Even though you're not combining to get something bigger, you're getting something more useful.
I'm
and I guess
also refreshing my stats. So
a
that I have
full heal and an evasion 3 Esper is pretty good.
When it comes in, it has vanish, which prevents it from taking damage or being targeted until the start of my next
turn. Also can move up to 10 hexes and shoot at a range of 6. Which, when backed up by the snow's energy pool there, is
pretty reasonable.
Alright, so I'm just going to move my guy back to the edge of the board to give myself as much time as I can.
Excellent. And this is where we hunt things down.
So basically, in order to kill this robot, I just need to roll some sixes. And that's it.
Do you just need to roll some sixes?
Three.
Probably.
You've made this very simple, Jesse. This game depends on how many sixes I can roll. Yeah, I'm good. Go.
Right. So you are. Let me read your robot for a moment. Do you have a potential?
Actually, I'm going to move this guy 1, 2, 3. Oh, there you go.
Jesse has 13 energy, I believe.
So I have a lot of energy. I have a 5. I have a 6 range on my Esper 4000's attack.
And you can actually move in range of that SSM.
I can.
And still be able to fire.
Can Jesse make it to here?
I believe he can.
Probably. Actually, if you get too close to me, I will push you off the board. I swear.
No, if he gets there, you won't be able to.
I swear I will.
Hold on. I have 13 energy.
Okay, go for it.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So I'm going to move 9 spaces.
Yep.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
I redubbed this game Aegis
Which
Super
puts
Combining Robots.
Me to 4 energy.
Okay.
I'm going to use my 4 energy
to shoot my face.
My attack to shoot your face.
Okay.
And as we discussed earlier, the Esper 4000's attack is...
It's RNG maximum. So,
yeah. So I hit on 5s or better.
And if you hit 6s, you deal
extra damage. So Jesse has turned this game into Breeze wants to roll 6s and Jesse wants to roll 6s.
I mean, I'm happy with 5s.
True. But those are
but
some
I
sixes.
But I got 2 sixes, so that's 4 damage.
Oh my god.
So that reduces you to 1 integrity?
I have 1 health. So I'm 1 health away from losing this game.
He is within the... He's in your not be able to shoot him with missile circle.
This is
correct.
True.
And you have 6 energy.
Scrap combined.
That's not a thing in this game mode. Otherwise, I would have used my god.
Okay, you know what? I'm going to twin buster shot you. I'm going to get 2 sixes, and you're going to lose.
All right, that's a strategy.
Here we go.
Jesse, you should have defense buffed it.
I can't. It has evade 3.
I think that's the only...
I thought about it.
I
it
think
has
that's,
evade 3.
That's the only thing I can do in this situation. Wait, no! No, what am I doing? I'm going to move over 2 spaces. I'm going to try...
you're going
to
spin on
I'm going to spin, because spinning actually has a decent chance to kill you.
Yeah.
All right, so I have 6 energy, used 2 of it. I'm down to 4 to move 2 spaces. And now we're going to zoom in on the action, man. We're going to go... This is the showdown. We got Einar versus Esper 4000. All right. Oh, yeah. All right, so I'm going to roll 2 dice. If they are 3s or above... Well, actually, If they're 3s or above, I deal damage to him.
He needs at least 1 6.
I need at least 1 6.
A 3 and above and a 6.
The 6s do the crits.
If I get a 6, I get 1 extra damage out of it because of crit. Let's do it.
One failure, so you did 2 damage.
Oh my god.
I got a 1 integrity.
I would like to say...
That wasn't actually in the plan to miss one of
I would
those.
Like to say that even if we succeed on that...
Wait. Like to call Judge...
On what?
Because my robot has a commander ability called First Pilot.
You have a commander ability called First Pilot.
Which you guys all thought that I would. You guys all thought that I would forget it.
Oh man.
So I would go. I'm gonna go down to 1, thus negating my chances of retaliation next turn. I'm gonna roll this and hopefully not. And I need a 3 or better.
Yeah. That's a 7.
Double 6s. Oh my god. There's my double 6.
So Jesse is not out of the game because he still has his snow.
Okay.
So all he has to do
is shoot me.
Is nail that SSM with a 2 damage laser.
Shoot me.
Which I believe, if you are standing here, you are actually able to shoot that.
So I have 7 energy.
Yep.
I'm going to spend 2 energy and move exactly to that space that kind of so helpfully highlighting for me.
And now you're going to shoot me with a laser, which will deal 2 damage.
Shoot you with a laser that has a reroll, which will do 2 damage if it succeeds, because we are right on that line.
Yeah, sure. I totally don't call. Line of sight on that.
You're not going to be able to re-roll it because you moved 2. You have 7 energy,
right.
You move 2.
I have 7 energy, I move 2. You're right. I won't be able to re-roll. I have 5 left.
Alright. Can Jesse not get a 1 this turn?
Can I not get a 1 this turn? That's the question. The answer is probably no. And then we have a really awkward game on our hands.
No, I think then I win.
Why?
Actually, no, wait. Snow 6000 is built like a...
There is a 1.
All right, I got this. We're gonna go
ahead.
We're going in the overtime, boys.
We're playing
so
a really
1,
weird game.
2, 3, 4, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm just out of range, so yeah, I'm just gonna move my guys in.
Okay.
And I'm gonna end my turn.
So
now
what Breeze did not pay attention to
what
is that he could have moved his SSM back behind the wall out of laser range, and now Jesse can re-roll his dice.
It at least means that we don't have to play an awkward game that takes an extra 10 turns for us to end it.
That is true.
So I'm going to roll.
You got this.
That is 2 ones.
I got 2 ones.
Oh my god. All right.
Go ahead.
This
I probably
awesome.
Lose now.
Well, you still have... How much HP does that thing have?
3.
3? Oh, that's right. I damaged it earlier in the game.
Yeah, taking a lot of damage.
I'm so good.
It's not doing very well. And I'm not succeeding very many dice rolls.
Actually, I'll just go up 1, 2 more. So I'm at 3, pay 2 energy, go down to 1, do the bayonets.
That's
oh, there
damage.
It is. That's 3
that's
damage.
The
oh! Wow. Comeback victory!
Victory for Breeze!
That was
so
close.
Yes, Dr.
There?
Nigel, we do stream every Wednesday. Starting around 7:30-ish.
It's a varying...
Give or take technical difficulty.
It's a varying stream every week. Somebody at all of my goddamn pretzels.
Excuse me, I haven't gotten any of those yet.
Where all the pretzels go? What the... This bag was full!
No, it wasn't.
It was
a half
it was,
full.
This
I
was
a
brand new bag of pretzels.
Half
full.
I had 0.
I'm sorry.
Just for the record.
Okay, so anyway, yeah, we stream every week. We do games on Tabletop Sim, but we also do art streams, production streams, and other stuff.
And we're doing some weird stuff next week.
Oh, yeah. Well, next week we're going to have guests come on.
Next week, I'm actually going to be running the stream because Breeze and Sarah will both be over in the land of sun.
We're going to be in California.
Woo!
Although, actually, they've been getting a lot of rain lately, so we're going to be in the land of sogginess.
Not snow.
It's not supposed to snow until PAX weekend,
I don't
so.
Want it to snow ever again.
Please never snow. I vote against snow.
So, next week, I am actually looking for if anyone of our viewers possibly wants to do a few games on stream with me.
So, yeah, we're going to...
And possibly Jesse, if he gets out of work on time.
Yeah. Anyone who's got that tabletop swim can play with Kettle or Jesse next week while we're over in California.
Or if people would rather see us do some weird stuff, we could just, like, play a different game. Yep. Talk about the merits of Excel spreadsheets.
I don't know, man. You guys should do combined Rondo point control.
So,
no. I'm going to stick with no.
I'll put a bit of a poll up on the Facebook page at some point, probably this weekend, and we'll let everyone have a bit of a vote on what we play.
We could do data visualization and AEGIS the stream, in which I just use Tableau and do a bunch of stuff.
AEGIS the stream.
Either that, or if you want us to do different stuff, Jesse and I both have games like Battle Rite and stuff like that. So,
yeah, if you wanted to watch us play shenanigans. Other games, we could do that.
Hey, Jesse, do you play Blood Bowl?
No, but I think I own it.
Such is the life of a Steam user.
Like Steam, yeah. I think I own that game.
Hold on, Breeze is on my Steam account right now. How many games are there?
So anyway, that was the game of AEGIS. That was the game of AEGIS combined Rondo, the magical tactical game where everything explodes and the rules don't matter, and also the points don't matter.
I don't know, the really rules mattered. Ended up mattering a bit towards the end.
The rules ended up mattering a bit. That was pretty...
That ended up being a pretty tense game at the end there.
Thought it was totally gonna go to Jesse. I was one health.
It was close to you at the beginning there.
Yeah, like it actually went back
basically
and forth.
Halved his entire team's health in the first two rounds.
But let's see. Do we want to do? And normally this would be even cooler if we had level fours and fives in the tabletop sim, but we don't.
We haven't loaded them yet because it takes a little bit of effort.
Yeah, so we don't have the level fours and fives to play with, which we should. How can I look inside of a deck?
Right click, search.
Right click. Oh, there we go. Search deck, okay.
So Breeze is currently.
As I was gonna say, if we wanted to do this,
we could throw together some teams real quick and
yeah, want to just
want to bonkers stuff.
Yeah, want to just like
do you
go.
Just let me build my favorite team right now.
Yeah, let's.
No,
just
you
go.
Guys have all the cards right here.
Yeah, let's just go stupid. So,
all right. Well,
okay.
I'm already calling dibs on this one.
Both of you, rock paper scissors on who gets to build what.
I'm calling
well,
dibs.
But who,
no,
whoever
fine.
Gets to
I
build
got it.
First.
None of us. None. Nothing that Jesse wants, I want anyway.
I'm calling dibs.
Okay. So, we will,
Where are the other level 3s?
Well,
zoom out a bit while Jesse builds his super secret team.
My super secret team? I don't think it's very secret.
I can't see it, so it is... I guess maybe they can, I don't know, I'm not really... I'm not paying attention, but I'm...
I think that's a bit...
Oh, there you go. Just
there we go.
Now
it's super
enough.
Secret.
No one will know.
All right, so
oh, yeah,
if you'll
totally.
Give us just
there
a couple of minutes...
Well, it doesn't need to be secret.
We'll,
gotta be a surprise, Breeze.
And build some teams real quick.
I'm
doing
just,
it live.
I don't trust you, so I'm just gonna I'm just gonna make a really dumb team.
Yeah,
I'm gonna play my
better.
Favorite robots.
Oh, this is gonna be good. Whenever Jesse does stuff with
robots.
His favorite robots, it gets pretty silly.
Pretty shenanigans, yeah. Remember, Jesse, you
search.
Are allowed 3 level 3 robots.
I could play 3 level 3 robots if I wanted.
Oh,
or 2 level 3s, a level 2, and a level 1.
So you think it's stronger to have
4.
Like 9 level 1s?
2 level 3s and 3 level 1s.
I feel like 9 level 1s could be really ridiculous just from like a versatility standpoint.
9 level 1s might be really strong.
Yeah.
You'll be
well,
capped out on energy for like the first 4 deaths.
Your downside is that you have to pay to combine, and your opponent didn't. So your opponent gets like roughly the same amount of power at no real cost to them.
I wonder if I can...
Thanks for stopping by.
I wonder if... let me think... if somebody plays a lot of level ones, I wonder what would Excelgon and like some of the other super high damage dealing robots. I just want to use all the really ham-fisted high damage robots well, against 9 level 1s and see if it works.
Excelgon
get
kind of silly in this
against
mode.
Level 1 robots seems like a lot of fun because I feel like you get to do lots of piercing.
What about just regular Etwall with a team of 8 other level 1 robots?
Oh my God.
What about Etwall's level 2 with a team of 7 other level 1s?
What about Etwall's level 3
with a team of
6
other
level 1
what
robots?
What about Etwall with level 1 robots? Have we considered that strategy?
What about... level 3 with 6 level 1 robots, all of which have some variety
oh my
of
God.
Self-destruct ability.
Which one of these robots has a long-range stun? Because I can totally handle that. It's going to lock Excelgon in place for 30 turns.
What? I'm not even playing the Excelgon team.
Yeah, I know.
Alright, I need somebody, by which I mean Kettle. Kettle, tell me about buffs.
I already have my turn.
Mm-hmm. Robots have good damage buffs?
The damage buff robots are like Arlie... And
are there any high level ones?
Arlie and Ats.
I don't know if we have any high level damage buff robots.
It's Arlie and Arrows do damage buffs.
And the new Sar, Mortar Sar.
Oh, big SAR, yeah. SAR is the best damage.
Dino SAR.
That's the level 2?
No,
it's level 1. Oh. Level 1 SAR had. Well, SAR, it's like SAR 100 or something.
Dude, I want a level 2 SAR. We gotta get on that. Got a few ideas kicking around.
We're gonna do like Grimlock.
Who's that, Grimlock?
Grimlock's gonna go in the game eventually.
Grimlock. Request for
Jesse,
Grimlock.
I mean not Jesse, Kettle, bring my pieces in. Where are my pieces?
Grimlock.
Oh, they're
stash.
In the bags.
Oh. Oh,
the
okay.
Bags are color coded and everything.
Oh. Oh, it's for really... Oh, for level 3, it's right here. Search.
Let's see.
Any pieces not in there should have already been on the board.
Oh, yep. Okay.
What do
so,
we got?
You know, I color coded this entire thing. Please.
Oh, yeah, that's right. All these guys are actually already out.
So easy, somebody who doesn't use T-Sim, can you?
Where's Snow 6000?
Oh, man. Do you know what team seems like it would be a lot of fun?
What?
Diane and Buff Robots.
Oh, man.
Also,
you mean
a level of strategy.
You mean
Diane
standard Diane team.
But with 4 extra levels of robots.
Oh, jeez.
Diane plus the snow plus the south plus something.
With that many robots, you have enough energy to give your snow retaliate.
All right, Jesse, are you done concocting?
Not quite. I think I'm pretty close, but I still have to put some
We should give people
in.
Something to look at besides, like,
I mean,
a
yeah,
rectangle
can,
in the middle of the green square. Yeah, I totally have a team.
Okay, we'll talk about your team.
Oh,
I'm gonna zoom in.
My team's gonna be really simple for anyone who's been watching, because
it is.
I'm using. I'm just using 3 level 3s, and they all have really long range attacks.
And they were all on the teams in the last game, but Ender Snow did not. Sorry, the Ender 5000 did not see use. Fun fact: the Ender 5000 used to be the Ender Snow,
but it still retains a laser, so it's fine.
Yeah.
So let's see, I have Cell 5000, I'm going to use this guy as kind of like, he's going to be my forward, and then Ender 5000 is going to be my mid,
oh, no.
And then my...
the SSM 3000 has been taken.
Have you chosen your
And then the Snow
well?
6000 is going to be my
SSM 3000 should just be on the board somewhere, because I was on the team's last game.
Is Breeze playing?
No.
No.
Oh, never mind, I'm using it. Give it.
You're not going to do crap to me, son.
Are
I don't have
sure?
any arcing.
So what Breeze has here is...
I have 3 level 3s, they're really strong, they're... There's a close range, a medium range, and a long range. Actually, I have no close range. I have 2 medium ranges and a long range.
So, what would have been really fun is if Breeze did the salve, the snow, and the get some, because then he'd have the standard MMO tank DPS healer.
Kettle.
Yeah, right.
As the administrator of this server, I have a request for you.
And what is that?
Can you please press the copy button on the salve so that I have it available to me if I choose to combine into it?
Wait. Oh.
Because it's
Can
really easy
that?
To duplicate assets in tabletop sim,
yeah,
as opposed to physical games. So if you're willing to, real quick, just give me a copy.
I don't know what you're talking
Perfect.
About. I didn't do anything.
Perfect. Duplication.
So one slight benefit of tabletop sim, as you can see, is we have to do some silliness.
Like just doubling up on some cards that we wouldn't otherwise have right away. So I have access to the salve on this team, potentially. And I am going to grab my chips real quick while Breeze talks more about his team.
That's 9 seconds. Alright. But anyway, so yeah, my team is, like I said, my team is actually very straightforward. I'm just going straight for, like, dumb MMO stuff. I mean,
MOBA
stuff.
If you have the get some, you'd feed the MMO stuff.
Yeah, so if I did, maybe I will actually let me look at the get some. Nah, I don't want the get some. I don't want him getting close to me. So I'm just going to shoot him.
But you want him to get some.
In every game that I play, like, RPGs, no matter what, I always do long range guys. Like, when I was playing Tales of the
Oh,
Abyss.
This is going to be a really silly game, then.
Yeah, great.
So,
oh,
Jesse,
wait,
is
oh,
your team
right,
ready
you
for
You already knew what I was playing.
Your
oh, yeah,
team ready for me to reveal? Or?
I'm just grabbing the chips, so if you want to reveal the cards...
So,
never mind,
Jesse's team...
I think I'm going to get owned, actually. So...
Oh, he's got some of my favorites here, too.
What are you doing? Okay, sure.
I'm doing some
Jesse is
stuff.
Using a team of 5 robots.
I predict at least some point Gamund is going to headbutt this Mortar SAR forward so they can actually shoot stuff.
I mean, the Mortar SAR is just there to buff the arrows.
Alright, enough theory crafting.
About.
Let's get to it, son.
No, we haven't gone over Jesse's team yet.
We haven't explained anything about what I'm doing. I also need to find the
people,
SSM chip.
People can definitely find out
Here's
while you
SSM
do it.
Chip.
So, Jesse, what team do you... What do you want to say about your team? Where do you want
so,
to start?
So, I want to start at the arrows, and I just want to explain real quick about the arrows.
Best place to
it's
start.
My favorite. So, the arrows is a level 3 robot. It has an arcing laser. Sorry, I moved stuff around.
Huh.
It has an arcing laser which is pretty powerful and lets it do a lot of damage at a long range. Then it also has an accuracy boosting laser and a defense debuffing laser, which I can use on my opponent. It has jamming too, so I can reroll enemy units' attacks to try and make them miss it. And
jamming two is pretty strong.
It also has overload, so if it stays still, I get to use two actions in a turn. That is also getting combined with my commander for the game, which is the GMD 100, piloted by Sunset General Gamund, who has an ability called Steady Fire, which says, on my turn, my units that don't move gain reroll one until the end of my turn.
Oh my god.
And so my strategy is that I'm going to sit still and shoot you. A lot.
So my question is, if he is the Sunset General, why does he need sunglasses?
I'm going to...
Because he's staring so at the sunset.
Have you ever driven into a sunset? It is very bright, can confirm.
So
the rest of his team is mostly based around supporting that. He's got a healer bot on there, which is very interesting.
There's an Enda 3000.
Which also gives me access to the Sal 5000 at...
And then he has one of my favorite rank ones in the game, which got up on that list after it helped me Wombo Combo Breeze combined with
also
Inika and an SSM.
In other really silly, I technically have access to this things. I can also technically create the... I can't make the get some because I don't have a get. But I can make something, I think. There's definitely like a weird robot that I just have access to, and I don't know why.
What he has here is the SOAR 100, which, as I said, personal favorite of mine. That 8-range damage buff's a lot of fun. But the cool thing about SOAR robots is they have zero movement, so they're basically just turrets. Which makes them really fun to design, actually. Mm-hmm. Do a lot of neat stuff with that.
Yep. Alright. So, let's do some rolling to see who goes first.
You got a random Esperiza right there. I'll just move.
Oh, yeah. You can clean up the board. There was some stuff that was floating.
It's all good.
I'm going to get owned. So
I'm going to roll these two yellow dice. Breeze, you roll them after me. I got a 10!
Pretty good.
You got a 10?
I got a 10.
Here, let's roll my dice. I got
not a 10.
That's right. A 9.
All right. Those yellow dice. All right, so I'm going to position my guys.
I'm actually fine.
So, Breeze, what are you doing over here?
I am actually just card countering Jesse's team real quick.
What?
No, that's unreasonable. Teams were already built, Breeze.
Nah.
Why are you doing that? Don't do that.
I'm not hard countering
You've
it.
You've pretty much hard
fun.
Countered it.
Breeze.
That doesn't make it fun. That's actually just waiting for me to show you my team and then rebuilding your team.
Beacon laser
Don't
shield.
Do that.
Beacon laser shield.
Don't do that. Don't do that. Play the team you wanted. Oh, no.
Wait, what just happened?
Okay, we're fine.
That was funny.
I tried to just delete your Enda and I deleted your Snow, too.
Oh.
So
okay,
just,
fine. If you want me to use Ender, whatever.
I'd like you to play the team you wanted to play. Because this is a very gimmicky team.
Okay.
That is the entire point of building your teams before revealing them to one another. So.
That's why there's a deck building aspect involved.
Are you sure?
Yes.
Are you positive?
I'm positive.
This is how board games work. Yes.
Alright, so I need to go. Okay, go.
Hold on. Wait, I have to... Hold on. We have to set up the turn one.
Yep, Dr. Nigel, if anyone has tabletop sim, they're welcome to message us on Facebook. And usually either Breeze or myself will probably... Pretty definitely have some time to play with you at some point. We'll work that out.
Yeah, so just message us and we can definitely pretty much get through any channel. Just be like, hey, I want to play AEGIS. We'll play AEGIS with you.
As well, if you would like it, we respond to all channels of communication.
Yeah, and there's usually somebody available most hours of the day who has some amount of time.
At least one of us, yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, we're probably the least active in the, like, 3 a.m. to, like, 7 a.m.
So if you want to play AEGIS, yeah, just message us at 3 a.m. We'll love it.
That'll go less well for you.
It's like 3 a.m. on a Tuesday. It's great, great.
Breeze doesn't go to bed until 5 a.m. some nights, so you should be fine.
All right. I am prepared. Are you prepared?
I'm prepared.
Alright, you got this.
Alright, how much energy do I have?
Oh,
yes.
6, 10, 13.
Oh, how much energy do I
have? 21, 27?
You have 25 14. Starting energy.
I maintain it definitely caps at 25.
At least for the moment. We might need to talk about that if we're doing level 1s. Oh no, all of the dice lost color.
Oh,
they didn't for me.
Oh, they did for me. Alright, if it's fine for the stream people, it'll
be great. 14 plus 8?
I'll just grab associated dice. 14 plus 8? is 22.
Okay, I got 22 energy.
All right. I'm going to start things off with the gravity burst field from my SSM 3000.
Why?
Because I want to push my robots.
Oh, I guess that's fair.
So I need to roll no ones, which I succeeded on.
That'll push everything in a radius 2 for
spaces.
Four
spaces, which is actually really only these two guys.
Yeah, so the way pushing works, even though it's radius 2, pushing only works along hexes.
Mm-hmm.
So in a straight line like that works,
and he's going to bounce against the
wall,
but
it won't work
one,
against Kamut.
Which would deal him damage if it were two spaces or more, but because it's one, he takes no damage. And then it's going to move my other guy over four spaces. I'm also going to flip that guy around so that he's...
pretty aggressive for a rank 2 self.
And then I'm going to move the GMD over his max movement of 3.
So the other fun thing to note with Jesse's commander choice is two of Breeze's robots fly.
Which makes my
Angamoon has a
very powerful,
pretty good anti-air 2 cannon.
And then the arrows is going to move 1, 2, and that's going to do it for my first turn. I'm just getting the setup.
All right, I got this.
So the other thing of note is Jesse cannot use his arcing laser shenanigans if Breeze has not moved yet.
Yeah, I have to give him at least a turn before I start shooting him.
Now, if Jesse was going second, would not have been much of a problem. But.
Yeah, I could have chosen to move second, but I think that setting up my team on turn one is better.
Actually, I'll move here. 5, 6.
All right.
And then is that... Now, the question is, draw me a line of sight. Can I hit Kamut from here?
I believe so.
Yeah.
The better question is, can you get shot back at
by Kamut
from there?
It's a long axis line, so yes, I...
No, you can't get hit back by Kamut.
Yeah, I believe you can...
Oh, yeah, no, I can totally hit you. Okay, so cool. So I move my guy up 6 spaces. My Ender 5000, he has a super infinite range laser, so I'm going to shoot you with it.
The Ender 5000 has a machine gun laser, actually.
And then I'm going to machine gun laser your face. I didn't even know he had white dice. How come they don't make white dice in real life? I've never seen white dice before.
What? Yes, you have.
So that's just because all the dice lose their color on the... non-host client when
actually,
the game
wait,
gets
did,
on
oh,
them.
That's what you guys were talking about.
Yeah. See, the colors are all good on my screen.
So I just dealt 3 damage to Gamund.
So Gamund takes 3.
Eat my butt. My entire butt, Jesse.
Alright, Gamund goes down to 3.
Didn't know you were into that, but...
What is that, Vor?
No.
I don't even know what that is, so I don't want to Google it either.
Eating butt? I don't think it's anything. I think that's just like... called like
eating
I think
butt.
That's just like I mean, a standard like ass play.
I mean,
fetish.
I just had like technically a... tossing salads.
Stop no. So but no the point is I just had a really great mental image of a manga panel with Jesse's face that just says eating butt ! With like shock lines behind
all
his
right,
head.
Then. Anyway,
I'm moving my guys. So 1, 2, 3 4, 5, 6, 7...
Breeze is small,
actually,
but elite
idiot.
Squad
I can just
of
fly
giant
over
robots.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and I'll move this guy here, and I'll be down to 4, and I'll end, and I'll... No, I want to close the gap as fast as possible. That's dumb. I'm not going to wait for you to hit me. Alright, so I'm going to go down to 0.
Yes, good. Set yourself up so that I can hit you.
Alright.
Okay. You're all set?
Yep.
So the fun thing about Jesse's team... is he has a lot of arcing long-range explosives.
So I'm going to start things off with the SAR.
Oh,
the SAR is going to start things off with a Wild Arms boost.
Wild Arms boost.
Targeting the arrows.
You can tell Breeze is the one who named these moves.
I have one failure, but because of my commander's ability Steady Fire, I can re-roll it because my SAR has not moved. So I'm going to re-roll that one. Into a 2,
whoa,
which will succeed. So my arrows get a damage boost. So then, we're taking off over there, huh?
Yeah, laptop is not happy.
So then I'm going to use the laser arrow Sol. And I'm going to target the Sal 5000 with the laser arrow Sol.
Thinking like up with this.
Which will cost me 4 energy. All of those dice will succeed. And so I'm going to go down to 17, and I'm going to do 4 damage to the salve.
That's fine.
Oof.
So all right. Salve goes down to 2.
Oh my god, what's happening over there?
I damage boosted the arrows, and then I shot your salve with the arrows.
Oh, okay. Yeah, alright. Seems good.
What up, Bray Fox?
Then the...
Oh my god. Oh, Bray Fox, yeah. you missed like the greatest game of all time because I won.
It was a pretty good comeback, not gonna lie.
But so when you look up the stream of this later, I was just looking at the first game because it was actually really, really cool.
It was.
Gamund is gonna move up.
But yeah, if you're tuning in now, we're doing a game mode called Combined
Rondo. Actually,
is Gamund
gonna move up?
I don't know. Is Gamund gonna move up?
I have to do some math.
My boss wants to play Combined Rondo. Sorry, Combined Rondo. I keep doing that in my head. I don't know why.
Dude, shoot me a message sometime. I'll totally play with you.
Suggestion if anybody wants to play Combined Rondo. I recommend you do play some standard games of AEGIS first.
Yeah.
But you get a good feel of how the game works, play Combined Rondo.
We're gonna go in.
Oh man.
And it might not work out.
Salve level 2 versus salve rank level 3.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7,
So the fun thing about salves is all of them have double move.
So from 17 to 9. Then I'm going to spend 3 energy. I'm going to use my radial damage ability, Degradation Field Nimbus.
Wait, what are you doing? Oh, salve, wait, you're killing my salve with your salve?
Coming in!
Oh, man.
What?
We're coming in, boys.
This is like War Turtle fighting Blastoise. This is bullshit.
Roll the dice, except that I failed my cannon. So you survive for another
turn. Straight.
And then with my 6 remaining energy, Gamund is going to move behind this wall. And the SSM is going to move up 1, 2, 3 spaces. And that makes it your turn.
Alright, let's see what I got. I guess I'm going to shoot you immediately with myself.
Okay.
So I'm going to pay 3. I'm going to start 22, go down 19, pay 3. Roll some dice. Roll 3 dice.
Miss.
Then...
Roll a one. That's a one.
Okay,
the
so
one.
The Wonder Swans are just dancing in the middle.
The Wonder Swans?
1, 2, 3. This guy can move 3, right? Yeah. So big guy.
That is in fact the movement value.
Screwed up my turn. I could have just. I don't know how to play. I don't know how to play games. So I could have just buffed my guy, and if I did something.
You could have attempted to buff your guy.
It's true.
Mm-hmm.
So 1, 2, 3. I'm down to 16 after moving those 3 spaces.
Go.
And then I guess I'm going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and just. My guy's just gonna jump right over that wall.
And just go hard.
He's just gonna, like, might guy over that wall. He's gonna dynamic entry, and he's gonna pay 3, and I'm just gonna try to nail you.
What attack are you using?
I'm gonna use a secondary attack, actually, because it's better at close range.
Alright.
And it is anti-air, so this will deal an extra damage to his guy.
As long as it succeeds at
least. So I'm looking for 3s. Each 3 deals damage.
Alright, we live.
That is 3 damage. It has 1 integrity left.
Alright.
Made it, boys.
That's my. Oh wait, no, I'm gonna. Yeah, it has reroll built in, so I'm gonna reroll that. Fuck you.
What? Well, you can't reroll.
You can only
not all three. Not all three, but I'll reroll this one. Okay. There, I'll even reroll into a failure just for you.
Yeah.
Jesse, because you had to complain the first time I rerolled.
I mean, you rerolled every single die. I would complain about
fraudulent
that if you did
re-rolls.
It in real life too. All
right, whatever. Go.
All right, I'm gonna go back up to 25.
It's a lot of energy you got there.
It is a lot.
I want to see what that pawn looks like.
We're going to start things off with the salve's degradation.
And that'll hit 2 robots this time.
If it succeeds.
Pop in the pawn folder.
Now, I also need to...
Now, the salve is not moving now, so it does get a reroll.
It does get a reroll, which is really cool in how it works with double roll. So we're going to...
Not that you need it.
Not that I need it. So I do 2 damage to both of your robots.
The salve... Rank 3 salve has been destroyed.
Uh-huh.
What?
Wonder Swan defeated
this
you.
This is ridiculous. I don't like this.
Good.
This is terrible.
And then it's gonna dirtle away.
What?
Why is dirtle...
Get back
the
here.
Best word?
I need that.
Because it's descriptive.
I'm gonna move back 8 spaces.
Are you kidding me?
How can you move back 8? You attacked already, you only get 1 movement, so move is 5.
That's not how double move works. Double move is move, attack, move, attack, move, 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 attack.
I'm sorry, can you say that again? I didn't get it.
No, no, double move is you can move, attack, move, or attack move.
Let's see what it says on the current iteration of the card.
This move unit may move twice this turn and after it performs actions.
Oh, I guess that is the
current.
I guess that is the current wording of double move.
Which has also been the design of the thing for
a while. No, before it said something different. We've like changed the way double move works like 3 times.
So it's back to the way it used to be.
Yeah, so,
the
yeah.
First time.
I just want to make it as intuitive as possible. So I guess, yeah, so that means you can hit somebody and then run away for 8.
And then be like, nah, peace.
Just the problem is, intuitive as possible gets broken when it gets passed through the mind of Jesse
Clark.
Nah,
it's fine.
Just beeline it.
It required me to survive that attack. It's fine. Well, the robot only has 4 integrity. I'm going to move my SSM 1.
Hey, you survived
punch
the attack better than he did.
Off the board.
No.
Why not?
Why would I do that?
Strategy?
I'm going to use the SAR. That's not a good strategy.
It is technically a strategy.
You're going to use the SAR?
I'm going to use the SAR to use the damage boost on my arrows.
That is the strat.
We're going to get the damage boost on the arrows.
Oh my god.
See?
Arrows is... Oh, see, I'm actually just going to get my... I'm going to get my butt ruined.
Yeah.
The SAR's first attack is actually really good, but... Everyone, I've found it's used a lot more as like more of a combo piece with that damage buff, because it combines really well with a lot of other stuff like SSMs.
Yeah, you could also use it. The arrows 100, I believe, functions similarly. If you're just looking for, the arrows 100 has a damage boost with basically the same stats on it. It's a little bit more of an offensive robot, but it actually produces 1 extra energy if you're looking for the combo piece.
That's fair.
So I'm going to roll my 4 dice. Yeah, it's SAR versus arrows.
Oh, yeah.
I missed one of the dice, but I have my commander ability. I'm going to spend 1 energy. I'm going to reroll this one.
He has his commander ability from Gamoon.
Which will succeed. So that's going to do 4 damage to the Ender 5000.
Which kills the Ender 5000.
What?
Destroys the
Ender. Oh my god.
Because the Ender 5000 took some damage from that Thunder Swan attack, too.
Attack from the swan that lived.
Oh my god.
The salve was really my salvation.
Just getting wrecked. Okay, sure.
And then I'm done?
So Jesse has a full team.
I have
with
9
almost
levels of
full
robots.
Health.
I just wanted to use 3 level 5. I just wanted to use 3 level 3s. Jesse's like, I'm going
to
construct my team.
I just wanted to use the arrows and the SSM and the good.
Now, if Jesse wanted to really be salty towards Breeze, he could just heal up his Gamoon using the salve.
You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to kill you with the snow because he has laser shield and you can't do anything to him.
You have to save yourself 2 energy every turn.
It's fine.
Don't you?
Absolutely. 7.
Which means you can't move and attack on the same turn.
Doesn't
if
matter.
Should only attack me.
You also can't get in range or the SAR will start murdering you.
You're all set?
Yep, I'm dirtling towards you.
You're dirtling towards me.
My guy
he
can't
is
really
just out of
well.
Range of the missiles.
I don't need no... Oh.
So, a lot of our rank 3 robots do fly, or have some form of extra movement attached to them. Outside of the Getsum, I believe, who is more of a I move you towards me sort of guy.
Alright, so I'm going to move my Gamund off 3 spaces. I'm going to move the salve over 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah. I'm going to utilize the salve's healing ability.
Because it actually matches our logo a little bit.
And I'm going to spend 3 energy and roll 3 dice.
So one of the differences between how the Salve 1000's always radial ability works versus the empowered ability of the Salve rank 3 is it can't catch itself in its own AoE with the rank 2.
So it is stuck at 1 integrity for the rest of this game. I have no other way of healing it. So it is kind of just going to play this weird flighty pokey game. And I'm going to move it up 2 more spaces.
But with double move, it's pretty good at that.
And then I am going to move the SSM over 1. And then I'm going to move the arrows up 2. And then I'm going to pass the turn.
All right. You know what I'm going to do?
What are you going to do?
How
are you going to do with my Gamoon slowly charging you?
1, 2... 3.
Push him off the board.
I'm just going to push him into a wall over and over.
Oh. 1, 2, 3. Whatever, I'm going to come around and get you. So go.
I'm going to move the Wonder Swan
are you?
In.
Jets currently do not blow up if they don't move.
I'm going to move the Wonder Swan in four spaces.
Because that led to certain things where you could just run the Ida rank 2 and instantly destroy Etwall.
It was great.
That was pretty fun.
It was fair.
I'm not usually the one who plays Etwall, so
I'm
that was
roll
pretty
three
great
dice.
For me.
Oh, wait, hold on. That was four dice. I'm sorry. Let me take a die away.
Still works.
I'm going to roll. No, I'm not taking that. No, that's not reasonable. I'm going to roll three dice, spending three energy to use the degradation, right? It's going to fail, but that's okay, because now my Wonder Swan will retreat in the way only a Wonder Swan backed by the power of an entire team can do. Then I'm going to move Gamund up one, two, three spaces.
So double move is a pretty strong ability, it
double
turns out.
Double move is really good when you have 25 energy. Who knew?
Oh my god. Alright, so anyway, are you done?
Hold on, I'm moving the arrows. I'm gonna move the arrows up.
But why?
Five.
Just
spaces.
Shoot me.
But then I just make you spend two energy. That doesn't do anything.
I guess not.
Then I'm going to move the SSM.
And to clarify, I'm saying that because my Snow 6000 has an ability called Laser Shield.
Go ahead. The difference between Jet and flying now is that Jet is better than flying.
Yeah, Jet is just specifically better than flying, but it's also faction locked, so you can't use it on every team.
Yeah, you can basically only get access to it if you're playing the blue guys.
And, but yeah, because we realized that, like, having a drawback mechanic, it's, like, cool, but it's, like, I mean, what's the
counter to
it? What's the downside to undying in Magic? There isn't one, and that's cool.
Yeah, but that was why I didn't like Undying as a mechanic and why I liked Persist.
Persist is
so, like,
also cool.
So, like, different people like different things. Undying felt like a really boring mechanic, but Persist is really cool.
I feel like there's more ways to break Persist creatures than Undying creatures, though.
But
except that the Undying creatures were all just good at fighting you. And so you didn't need to break them because they just killed you.
That's true.
Strangler Geist is a really good card.
The other thing about it is evasive units. I wanted more things to help evasive units, you know, evade and move really easily without spending half of your team's energy to rush across the board. So just having evasive units that can specifically get across the board for very, very little energy, I feel balances them out a little bit. Because right now they're just like, we suck up energy.
Dr. Nigel, that is in fact a Triceratops with a cannon and sunglasses.
Absolutely.
It also came around, the change to Jet also came around the same time as the update to Evade, which changes things as well a little bit
for most
of those robots. Because we made it so that ranged evade applies if attacks are hitting you from range, and melee evade attacks applies if attacks are hitting you up close.
Yep.
And so that makes it, as opposed to specific melee attacks being impact.
Exactly.
So we also added in that new Ida rank 1, whose first attack would have been really good against Etwall.
In general, between like the last time we printed the cards and when the final version of the game, E-types got like a bit better and more versatile. So like a team of E-types no longer is like completely unviable.
I'd still play at least one like A or S in there.
But out of all the teams, like Team of A is fine, Team of S is fine, Team of G is great.
I'd probably go with the accuracy.
They all have like their
own team.
Team of I is kind of okay.
Yeah, but
you
like
just have
before
to play a really weird strategy.
Yeah,
but Team of A's was unplayable.
Team of I's is basically just the Rios team at this point with like some gel thrown in.
I mean, sure, if you go the
PM, oh, that's right. I need to roll two more dice. I'm a dumb. I'm shooting you with my damage laser. I hit you with my damage laser. Gamund
takes
two damage.
Gamund takes two. Gamund goes back to three.
Gamund retaliates.
All right.
For the one damage ping. Let's go. Ping. I'm going to roll this one die that's
that
in the middle of the board.
Me. I feel like...
Six. One damage.
Oh my god.
Pop, watching robots drop.
Pop.
So I feel like...
Oh yeah, that's right. Not only were E-types like not good on a team altogether, but they also... There was a specific mechanic in the game called anti-air...
That was good against E-types.
Poo-pooed on them. But it's also more of a thing to deal with combined robots than E-types specifically. But it also, poo-pooed on E-types.
And there are some non-flying E-types who don't get hurt.
It kind of helps a little.
All right. What next?
Made some adjustments to
that. Are you doing anything else? Are you out of energy?
Yep, I'm done.
All right, are your shields down?
My shields are down. You can shoot me or you can shoot my shields.
I can shoot
Fox, I remember giving you the Rios team that one time. That was a good game.
I'm gonna fire.
Personal favorite of mine too.
I'm not gonna fire. I'm gonna use the salve. I'm gonna use the salve to heal my guy.
Healing good.
Healing is great.
Here and it heals for exactly as much damage as Breeze's damaging laser does.
Oh, we succeeded. So Gamund goes back to 5.
Oh my god.
Gamund is going to approach.
Kill me!
Gamund is approaching! These things take time.
He'll get there eventually.
Shoot. Shoot me.
I'm going to use the arrows. I'm going to fire a laser.
I can pretty effectively.
Actually, hold on. I'm going to move.
I'm at 6 health. What are you moving for?
You'll see. It'll come up.
It'll come up.
I'm going to spend 4 energy.
It'll come up, he says.
I'm going to roll 4 dice. I need no ones. I don't have a reroll available.
Oh, look, that's no ones.
It didn't matter. Got right, no so ones.
4 damage?
3 damage.
3 damage.
I can't buff him right now because he moved away from my SAR. And then the SSM will steadily approach you as well.
Yep.
And that's going to be my turn.
Oh, the slow turtles are coming in for the
kill. The right. Charge.
The slow.
War turtle brought down the Blastoise.
I'm going to see if I can end this game without being completely BTFO. So I'm just going to,
Before you shooting my
I'm gonna shoot Salve.
Why are you trying to destroy the Swan?
I'm gonna shoot the Wonder Swan.
What did it ever do to you?
I got a 1.
Yay!
I don't have enough energy to reroll if I have a reroll. What does this guy do? Yeah, he's
he
totally
reroll.
A reroll. Yeah, I don't have
no energy.
I got the, yep. I had to move 2 to do that, so I'm screwed. Alright, go!
Alright.
Pull me over.
I'm gonna use Gamund's swaggering head ram.
Also, Brie Fox, you missed it earlier, whatchamacallit.
3 dice.
The Ion rank 3 drained most of Breeze's team.
Well, no, I don't care about that.
I'm going to succeed. I'm going to push you 6 spaces into a wall. You're going to take 2 damage.
Oh my god.
Are you at 1 integrity? Is
yes,
that
I am now at 1 integrity.
You were at 1 integrity. Fire the missiles.
Fire Z missiles.
We got a new... We've started getting passes on our Kickstarter video. So while everyone's giving all of their money to Thunderstone and GKR, yeah, we're getting ever closer to
just
doing
so your
this.
Team needs more DACA.
Here comes the roll. I'm looking for 5s or better. HP just told me to register my PC. I got a success.
1 success.
1 damage to you and to the Gamund, and that destroys your last robot.
I lose. Which is fair because I totally trounced you in the first game with dice rolls.
Trounced. That game was close.
That game was so back and forth.
4.5 hours.
Who were yeah. So, do we have any retrospective on this game? Mr. Clark.
The Arrows is a very powerful robot who does a lot of things. It works really well when you can put it on Kaboon's team.
Now, he might be slightly biased because the Arrows is, in fact, on his business card, so he might like that robot a bit much.
The Arrows is great.
Like, what a workshop.
Well, anyway, yeah, so that...
So, Mr. Hrigos, do you have any retrospective on this match?
I chose really ham-fistedly just to test out what 3 level 3s would do, and Jesse chose a team that was specifically going... had a strategy.
Yes.
I did
pick a strategy and then also put a swan on.
And that strategy was pretty often deal 4 damage to one of your robots of his choice every turn.
Yes. It was, he shot me from orbit.
But I think we can all agree, the real MVP of this match was the Wonder Swan.
The Wonder Swan definitely.
Salve rank 2.
Did a lot.
Because I believe that brought down 2 of his robots and healed your Gamund.
And healed my Gamund for a total of 4 and did 2 damage to the... No, did... Yeah, and did 2 damage to the snow. It
2 damage
just did a lot.
But it's that 2 damage from it that brought down both
the
Salve rank 3 and the
Ender.
So.
Yeah. It managed to destroy 2 robots with its mighty wings.
So, do we have any closing thoughts?
This game mode is absurd.
Yeah, you're gonna love
absurdly
it.
Fun.
Combined Rondo is like the coolest
absurd.
Thing ever.
It's real. There's a lot to think about.
We have tried this mode with some rank 4s and rank 5s before, and it gets kind of silly.
It definitely gets sillier when you have the higher level robots. As is, it already gets your ears going. It makes you think. But it definitely, when you have options...
I
want to
try that 9 level 1 robot team at some point.
You can't even place them all in this current map design. You only have 7 places to place robots.
I will make them.
Maybe that's the hard limit too. You probably shouldn't have 9 robots on your team. To be fair,
so I should have 7. I don't think it's good to have them if you have a 25 energy cap. I think it's bad to do that unless you're playing like 9 G types.
I think caps are okay.
What if you play 9 G types? What if I play Monogon?
What if I play 9?
Monogon and 1 E-types, so you can make the rank 2 gon.
And the goth. Let's not forget the goth.
And the goth, so you can defense buff all of your other gons.
Yeah. Hold on, let me build that team real quick.
Oh my god. So anyway,
I don't want to play it, I just want to look at it.
So me and Sarah, we're going to California next week. Woo! I have a board artist on tap trying to get some art from him.
Jesse and I will be putting up a poll probably this weekend, seeing what everyone wants the stream to be next week. It's going to be pretty chill.
Yep. And then but back on the Kickstarter front, game's definitely coming along. Like I said, we got video happening now. Music track's almost done to coincide with the video. And then once we get the board art, we take new how to play videos. Our artist was at KatsuCon over the weekend. So it's like, please get us art.
And then we go to PAX, and after we're done filling up on cough drops all weekend.
It's gonna get close. If you're gonna be at PAX East, and everybody should be at PAX East, just to let you guys know again, we have a panel called Fighting Robots attacking a theme from different angles, with
Mech
a bunch.
Mech's gonna be on it. Sorry.
Yeah, with a bunch of other robot game designers like Mech Deck, and PBL Robots, Rise of the Robotariat, Giga Robo,
and Out Chasers.
So that will be neat. And then look for a really awesome thing coming in the near future. It's all coming together. If your friends don't know about AEGIS, please continue to tell them about AEGIS. Maybe one day we can fund in 4.5 hours like GKR Killer Robots. If only we were Weta Workshop. It's like, but yeah.
We're better. We're Zephyr Workshop.
Exactly. Oh my god, you're right. Fucking Zephyr.
Our first word has like
we did a couple more letters. We did the special effects for like the trend for the Lord of the Rings ripoff movies, actually. Weta Workshop did Lord of the Rings. We did we did Duchess of the Bangles.
Bangles?
Yeah, Duchess of the Bangles. We produced all of the special effects for Duchess of the Bangles, and therefore
I prefer Duke of the Bling.
And Duke of the Bling. So that obviously means our Kickstarter should fund in 3 minutes. I want our Kickstarter to fund in 3 minutes.
All right, so you're lucky. Duchess of the Bangles, not a thing.
Okay, get on copywriting that. We're making a new board game.
I'm buying Duchess of the Bangles.
Duke of the Bling is an eBay store.
But no, Duchess
sells women's rings.
Duchess of the Bangles.com. Gotta get duchessofthebangles.com. I'm gonna buy that right now.
I'm looking at Duke of Bling right now. Let's see what we got here.
Anything tasteful?
Ooh, a black tungsten ring with a thin blue line.
Ooh. Mm. Also, random thought. For anyone who goes to PAX, stop, come by our booth, play a game, and we have sweet promos.
We will indeed have sweet promos.
The $13 gold skull ring.
We have a special art under 5,000 that we're giving out at PAX for people who come by and say hi and demo.
We might have a couple of the promos from last year.
Oh yeah, I think we have a few of last year's level 4 robots in a shoebox that we're going to bring too.
Which is what happens when we print thousands of promos.
We actually don't have that many left.
The only ones we have is like the Ender.
We only have 2 of the 3 in stock, and I think there's like very few.
Yeah,
there's very few of one of them. The Ender combined has a bit.
I don't know. I was looking at them last.
They're definitely low.
Definitely.
I'm not saying that there's a ton left. I'm just saying that.
But yeah, so you can.
Like,
if you missed us last year, just come and find us at PAX this year. We'll be in the tabletop free play area, and also we'll probably have some signage at the Greenbrier booth or something that at least point you towards where we are. And yeah, super, super awesome, guys. We won't be here on the stream next week, but Kettle and Jesse will, and he will play with anybody who wants to play. And you can play with whatever game mode you want.
I'll be putting up a poll on Facebook.
Try and get some people in.
Try and figure out what we want
games
to do. Jesse and I can just, like, goof around with random Steam games, too. We both have pretty
I can force Kettle to play a jerk for 2 hours and see how he does.
So basically, he will force me to play the tutorial for a jerk.
I'll get him to play the new Tails game for 2 hours, and then I'll get right to the good part. Yeah, and he'll just be like, oh my god, it's time to leave.
And, so, I mean, if you want to play something other than Aegis at some point, you can also show me a message. I want to try and drag Jesse through Magicka.
Oh no, I hate that game. Yeah, right. I hate everything about that game. That game is my least favorite because I did not find it fun to play alone or with people.
But yeah, no, I'll see you guys soon. Look for updates and stuff.
We should have a post going out tomorrow giving some more detail on those PAX panels.
Absolutely.
As well as general plans for the next couple weeks. Going to be pretty busy.
Yeah, we're kind of boiling down here. So we're going to get that game out.
Look at these sick legs on the Snow 2000 real quick.
And I think Sarah's in the less exciting but very, very relevant stuff. Sarah's done like 10 meetings this week with shipping people, manufacturing people. So we just continue to getting more and more numbers and more options,
talking
and learning
to
about
all
everything.
The people.
Literally just talking to everybody. So that's good. Yeah. Stay by our side and we can get this game out, people.
Brie Fox, Dr. Nigel, hop on the stream next week and all three of us can drag Jesse through Magicka.
Oh, no. Don't do that to me.
That's kind of
please don't awesome. Do that to me.
Yeah, right.
Oh, we have a request to flip the table. Five,
yeah, baby.
Four, three, two, one. Wait.
God.
Whoa, you didn't let me put the tabletops in back open on Breeze's laptop so it would die.
Oh, no, oh. Go, stop. Don't
oh,
do that.
We could unflip the table and do that.
We could.
His laptop on fire.
It's very upset. No, wait, the laptop.
It's really funny because it sounds like it's taking off.
This is like struggles to do physics.
Bye.
Double table
Yay.
Flip for you guys this week.
Yay, table flipping.
Almost as fun as dragging Jesse through Magicka.
Don't do that.
I mean, if we want to play like better co-op, we could do like Monaco or something.
But yeah, we'll be further refining the rules to combine Rondo.
Yeah,
and it'll be
the combine Rondo is something that we've done in very limited bursts.
And it'll
it's kind of complex, and we've sort of all agreed that it's just going to be broken.
But it's
we sort of
really
all agreed
great.
That it's just a lot of fun to mess.
There's yeah, I'm not
mess around with.
I'm not convinced that it isn't solvable. But I don't know if that's a problem necessarily.
Mm-hmm.
I also don't know how you solve it. I don't know what is the solution.
I don't know. You did that really fun thing with the rank 5 that one time in testing.
Oh, yeah. Which rank 5 was I using?
That was the arc.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. That was fun. Wasn't that with the really awkward wording on arc, though? I think we fixed that.
Oh.
Wasn't that back when arc went infinite?
Yeah, I think you made sure to fix that as soon as that game finished.
Because I went, oh yeah, you can just storm out. That's probably a problem.
Probably not the best idea.
Right.
Is there still... Hold on.
Oh, no.
Not that the stream needs to know about this necessarily, but I'm curious if there's still a game of Fire Emblem going on Tabletop Simulator.
Oh,
so that I can message them and be like, how did you do it? Alright, it's not there anymore. I'm just so confused. I want to know how they did it.
We should Google it. And maybe
well, are they playing like some sort of weird Fire Emblem board game? Or
I've never heard of a Fire Emblem board game, which is why I wanted to know.
Well, maybe they like derp.
Maybe they invented Fire Emblem the board game.
Yeah, it's probably not that hard. There's an Advance Wars board game that's just called like Wars Advance or something. It has like all the same art and graphics.
Fire Emblem Tabletop Simulator. I'm going on the Tabletop Sim Reddit. There's apparently a Fire Emblem RPG. That is
made. I bet that it's like a D&D type thing.
Yeah.
But anyway,
I could see that.
But anyway, let's wrap.
We are closing off for the night. Have a good night, everyone.
Have a good morning.
Good night.
404 not found.